they've got these.
No.
I hate that. So I kept the one that you did.
Yes. Because it had it in America.
Beer. Beer.
Beer. Not bottle.
Right.
Okay. Beer.
Lolithan, Isley, Kramer.
That's about it, then. This is pretty simple.
Sports presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Park National Bank, Dagger Law, the Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, Fairfield Federal, Standing Stone Bank, Fairfield DD, North Body Shop, Personal Touch Party Rentals and Events, the Edwards Insurance Agency, Buckeye Toyota, The Carriage Company, Huddle Tire and Auto, the Fairfield County Commissioner's Office, South Central Power, Sheridan Funeral Home, and Buckeye Lake Marina.
And good evening, everybody. Welcome to the Interphase Video Productions High School Football Game of the Week. I'm Jared Stewart alongside Tim Shoemaker and Marion Royster down on the field tonight. It is round two of the Division 7 Region 27 playoffs as the Berne Union Rockets host the River Pilots and Shoe. We are in for a dandy tonight. Both these teams on a roll. Obviously, Berne Union coming in undefeated, while River comes in winners of their last five contests.
Yeah, both teams averaging, one's averaging 49 in River and the other one's averaging 50 points in Berne Union. And I know Coach Herb said, we told our guys they're probably going to score, but we just got to limit it.
Want to say thanks to Personal Touch Party Rentals. They are our pregame sponsor. Carol and Eric Whittington would like to invite you to stop by Personal Touch Party Rentals and Events in Lancaster. They are a small family-owned business and have been serving the Central Ohio area since 2003. They would love to help you plan your next event, weddings, special events, even corporate events, all with a personal touch. That can be reached at 740-689-6991. Want to throw it down to the field to our third member of our crew, Marion Royster. Marion, good to see you tonight.
Good to see you too, Jared. Great to be with you guys tonight. It should be a great matchup that we have here. Great weather tonight. Hasn't gotten too cold. Should be, you know, around 30, 40 degrees. So two teams should have good opportunity to continue to, you know, put on the high-powered show that they've had throughout the season.
Got a lot to talk about with this contest. A lot of information from both these teams as they've had outstanding seasons. Our kickoff just about set to be teed up. Kickoff tonight brought to you by Sheridan Funeral Home. Sheridan Funeral Home is proud to be supporting high school football. They've been serving the communities of Lancaster and Fairfield County for over 100 years. It will be the River Pilots taking the opening kick from Coach Tony Herbst's Berne Union Rockets, who come in 10-0 tonight, ranked number 2 in Division 7, Region 27. River was the 7th seeded team out of the OVAC. Double-A level. This is their 5th trip in the last 6 seasons. 5th trip to the playoffs. Back deep for River will be, looks like number 13, River Thompson. Also Lolithan and Birdie Longwell back there. Bray Friesner will tee it up and kick it away for Berne Union. He gets a lot of action, not just running the football, but he's done an outstanding job doing the kicking duties as well this year. And the opening kickoff will go out of bounds, so the River Pilots will have excellent starting position. And Tim, let's talk about this this River football team as we get into our keys of the game. Coach Mike Flannery, what a tradition. His family has quite a tradition with River football.
Well, his father started the program over in Hannibal, Eastern Ohio, in 1957.
Wow.
And the field was actually named after him, so he's coaching on a field named after his father. How neat is that?
That is awesome. Out of the wishbone. Handoff goes to Brody Lolithan, the 5'10", 170-pound junior. He'll pick up about a yard on the play.
Well, the interesting thing about Brody actually was a quarterback earlier in the season.
Wow.
And he's taken the move here, and, you know, he's had a nice season himself with gaining over 350 yards, scored 5 touchdowns.
That offensive line for River is quite big and quite possibly the best size that Berne Union has had to face this year.
Well, I know Coach Flannery said Berne Union, he felt that was this is the biggest team besides Marietta High School that they've seen.
On second down, Kramer picks up about 4, so it's a 3rd down and 3 coming up for the Pilots. Isley gives it off, and he's got enough for the first down across the 45. On the carry is Avery Kramer, the 5'11", 175-pound senior.
And his brother, which is a twin, is in the backfield with him.
Wow. Both of them having outstanding seasons as well. Caleb Isley, the quarterback, has thrown for over 1,700 yards and 22 touchdowns, only 3 interceptions on the season. This time, Isley gives off right side, and a nice job by the Rocket defense, stopping him for no gain.
I'll make a correction on that. Coach, spoke with Coach Flanagan in the notes, he said, oh, by the way, Isley only has two interceptions. So
wow.
I said, well, we'll make an accurate on that. I said, I'll fix that on game night.
Second down and 10 after no gain on first down.
Yeah, you know, he talked about the bone, and really it's more of the straight T formation, Jared.
Lotlatham on the carry here across midfield is going to bring up a third down and about six. Marion, what's the atmosphere like down there? We've got a packed house here on the Berne Union side. Are those the Rockets fired up on the sideline?
Yeah, it's been a really live, been a really live sideline. You can tell the Rockets are really ready for their first or their second playoff game again this season. They have an opportunity to do a lot, and this offense, you know, always gives them a lot to cheer about. So I expect a lot of cheering here going forward.
Isley, quick give up the middle to the first man through. I think he's going to be shy of the first down by about a yard. Needs to get to the 44, and he stopped at the 45. Fourth down and one coming up for the Pilots.
Well, they've done nothing but just line up and run the football here, Joe. They're three backs. As I said, it's more of a T formation look than it really is a wishbone look.
Is this the kind of offense that may lull you to sleep with that run, and then they'll hit you with that pass?
Maybe. I mean, you talked about, you know, Isley's passing yardage and 64% passing efficiency.
On fourth and one, they go for it, and they will get the first down.
Yeah, Jared, real quick to your point, I did see a couple clips for River before the game, and Isley does have that ability to pick up and throw, you know, a deep ball when unexpected, and he's very accurate when he does so.
Methodical drive here for the River Pilots. All run so far. They pick up the first down. They're moving the football and chewing up time in this first quarter. Isley this time going to be met in the backfield and slammed down by number 50. That's James Ashton for the Rockets.
Yeah, Cable Isley, he's only a sophomore.
Watch the replay here. First man to hit him was Friesner, and then here comes Ashton.
Great penetration.
Puts them all the way back to the 49.
You know, Coach Herb spoke earlier in the year about, you know, they move their people a lot, and they will blitz, and they do a lot of different things. There's a lot of movement in their defense.
Yeah. Here we see a different look. Isley out of the shotgun, high snap, tucks it, and he's going to keep it. Hits his own man at the 45 and heads forward. It gets back to the near the original line of scrimmage, and a late flag comes in. We saw a body go flying late. We'll have to see who that's on. And there comes another late flag coming in. Really late. I think this might be on Berne Union, the last one. We'll check the penalties. Both of them coming in late. Get our officials for you here momentarily from down in the truck. They're having a conference now to figure out what's what here on these late penalties. We'll get the call.
Dead ball. Personal foul. Defense, number 76. 15-yard penalty. First down.
So they only mentioned the one personal foul. And then the last one was a sideline warning
River.
On River.
On me? For what?
Well, that's pretty clear.
Carter Carpenter, you can clearly hear him. On me? For what?
Yeah. Well, I thought he said 76.
I thought he said 76 as well.
Yeah.
There's the officials tonight.
Yeah, referee, I know he's from the Coshocton County, Jim O'Donnell, Peter Tamborelli, Tim Maddox, Mark Prissy, Scott Welker is the back judge, and Dan LaRue. And just a note on Scott Welker, he is the commissioner of the Muskingum Valley League.
Nice.
Outstanding three-sport official, Jared.
Yeah. First and 10 River after the 15-yard penalty. That got him off the hook. And first man through this time is Austin Kramer.
Yeah, they're really having success with this three-back. You know, there's only one time that Berne has really slowed them and stopped it. You know, it was interesting with being – and Mike Flannery from River talked about they've run a lot of this three back, but then they go, like you said, a different formation. Yeah. They spread, yeah, which is almost something totally different that you have to defend. So you got to defend two separate kind of offenses.
Right.
And you can see here, here's the spread again. No backs.
Second and six, Lolathan in motion. He'll take the give, and we got a flag coming in as Lolathan's up near the first down. But this might be a hold on the Pilots. It does look like the official is motioning that way. We'll get the official call here. So it is a hold on the Pilots. Let's get to our keys of the game, brought to you by North Body Shop, providing quality customer service, parts, and reliability since 1979. Owner Mark North will provide you with a free written warranty on each estimate. That's
holding.
Mark North of North Body Shop.
Offense.
He'll
number
treat you
54.
Right.
10-yard penalty, second down.
Well, I think the biggest key, and you're seeing it here in the first half of the first quarter with River, is they want to maintain the ball. The best way to play defense against an explosive offense is don't let them have the
yeah,
ball.
Yeah.
Easier said than you know.
That's true.
Putting out there, but they are having a really good drive here.
On second down and long, it's Kramer, Avery Kramer, on the carry this time. It's going to bring up a third down and about 14. Clock rolls down to 6:08 and counting.
I mean, Jared, we're going to be halfway through the first quarter.
Yeah. Before Berne even touches the football.
They haven't even had a possession. So I'm not sure how many plays we have right now in for River. But, you know, it's building rhythm for them offensively.
Well, and what's the best way to keep that high-powered Berne offense off the field is control it on their offensive side for River. So, you know, it covers two things there. So great game plan so far for River, guys.
We do have a timeout on the field. River takes one. Tonight's timeouts are being brought to you by the Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive in Lancaster. Learn more at carriagecompany.com. Tim, let's talk about how these teams got here. Berne Union in their opening round of the playoffs last week. They knocked off Rosecrans, a league foe, 58-14. Hannibal River, they knocked off Woodsfield Monroe Central, another team close to them, by a score of 49-6 to get here.
Well, not only are they close to them, they're in the same school district. It's the Switzerland of Ohio local school district. Yeah, and you can see right here what you just talked about, Jared. And there are three schools within that district. You look at Bellsville, and you have Monroe Central. Monroe Central is made up of a consolidation back in the 90s of Skyview and Woodsfield.
Huh.
So it's an interesting area.
Yeah.
If you've never been to Monroe County, you need to take a visit sometime.
Third down and long. Screen pass. Hits his man. That's Austin Kramer. Kramer trying to get around the corner. Gets near the 30-yard line, or near the 20-yard line. That's going to be shy of the first down by about 5 yards.
I we also give a comment on the down marker over there.
I love it.
Yes. It's lit. I mean, it's easy to see. There's some nights we're not really sure what it says.
Here's a replay on that screen pass.
Yeah, really set up well. Nice play, though, by number two here, Friesner.
Yeah, just didn't have anybody out there to block him.
No, and he came and made an open field tackle, which isn't always easy on an athlete.
Fourth down and four. Could be a big stop here for Berne Union after this long drive from the Pilots. Passes out. It's complete. And across the 15, out of bounds at the 14-yard line. That'll be a first down for the Pilots.
Well, he does throw a nice ball.
Yes, he does. On the reception, that's the tight end there, Brody Longwell. Go ahead, Marion.
No, I was going to say, that had some incredible zip on that ball. Isley on that one. He throws a really, really nice ball, guys. Has been very accurate on throughout stretches in this game. Had one game where he went 10 of 11 through a stretch, so he can really deliver the football when needed in this offense.
That's impressive, 10 of 11. They continue this drive here, chewing up a lot of time, already down to 5:03 to play in the first quarter. First man through, he's going to bust through for a touchdown for the Pilots. That's Austin Kramer. It's like he was shot out of a cannon. He was past that initial surge of that defensive line in a hurry.
That's the 17th time he scored this year. That's a lot. Watch here. Well, we don't really get to see the hole that the line did such an excellent job of. You know, there's a drive, Jared, that you're looking at 7-minute drive.
Yeah. Zach Hocutt will be kicking the PAT. And it's blocked. that could come up huge in this game.
Yeah, that's an interesting thing. The kicker for River, what'd you say his name
was? Hocut.
Yeah. He is considered one of the best in the Ohio Valley area over there. And that's a big play for the Rockets to get in. You can see the pressure right here.
See who got a hand on it.
Not a kicker's problem right there. A lot of penetration up the middle.
Yeah, that wasn't anybody that came from the side. That was right in the middle.
No, they just forced their way through. And
20, no, it was
number eight.
Number eight for the Rockets. That's Ian Staten.
Yeah, we usually recognize him as his tight end play on offense.
Yeah.
And that's a nice play on special teams.
We'll see how that comes into play here later on. Those extra points are always extremely important.
And especially, you know, we're getting to the level now where, you know, these teams are starting to sort out, you know.
Yeah.
We've got good competition. The first week, I'm not going to knock anybody, but, you know, there was a lot of heavily weighted favorites,
yeah,
and it came through that way.
Right. Well, we're about to see our first look at Berne Union in this second week of the playoffs, led by Coach Tony Herbst. It's his fourth season down here in Sugar Grove, has a 30-10 record with the Rockets. The Rockets rank second in Division 7, Region 27. On the return, it'll be Friesner, a deep kick, and Friesner out to the 15, and going to be wrapped up and driven backwards. The forward progress looks like they'll give him out to right at the 15-yard line.
That's very good coverage, because as we know, Friesner's dangerous.
Let's get our first look at this Berne Union Rockets offense. High-powered, led by Nate Nimeth, the quarterback, 40 of 73 passing. 55%, 901 yards on the season, 12 TDs, but I would say maybe more impressive is his running. 71 carries, 991 yards, 14 yards per carry, 22 touchdowns with his feet. And, of course, he's got help behind him with Bray Friesner, who's rushed for over 1,600 yards this season. Out of the shotgun, Nimeth, a pitch out to Friesner. Friesner with some running room and some speed. He's not going to be touched.
No.
Friesner down to the 20, the 10, 5, and a touchdown Rockets on their first play from scrimmage. 85 yards.
Well, you know, they really went no backs. What a great design play right there. Flip it out and get Friesner in space.
He went from the far side of the field and came all the way to this near side. And once he's in open air, you're not catching him.
What a terrific design, though, Jared. Fantastic.
And now he's got to kick the extra point, guys, and he's pretty winded, so we'll see how this goes.
Good point.
Yeah, he just ran 85 yards for a touchdown, and he's like, can I get a breather here? It'll be out of the hold of Nate Nimeth.
Well, he's 82% on his extra points, so pretty good stuff.
And it is good, and the Rockets take a 7-6 lead with 4:30 to play in the first quarter.
He may have been tired up top, but his leg was good.
Boy, what a tale of two different drives there, right? I mean,
now
River
remember,
chews up a clock and one play, and Berne Union's in the
one play is not a drive, Jared. I've had this discussion before over the years.
It's not a drive.
That's
no drive summary.
No.
So with 4:30 to play in the first quarter, the Rockets take a 7-6 lead, and already we're seeing the effects of that missed PAT from River.
Well, if it keeps going this way, like we said, we think it's going to be a shootout.
Yeah.
You know, if you can get a turnover, make a big play, it can determine the result of what happens tonight.
Yeah. Mentioned Friesner, 97 carries, 614 yards, 16.5 yards per carry. He's got 23 touchdowns on the season. He's averaging 161 yards per game, and on one carry tonight, he's got 85.
You got half of them.
Tells you a little bit about that 16.9 yards per carry, guys. How would he has ones like that?
Yeah.
Although that might have been a pass. I think that might have been considered a pass
in
the statute.
We'll
have to check
like it,
that. Yeah.
I'd have to look at that and see whether that pass was forward or just a backward flip.
Almost looked like just kind of straight to the side. Got to give credit to that offensive line, though. They are they are big and they physical. They do a nice job, led by Carter Carpenter, number 77, 6'5", 305-pound senior. And a little pooch kick here will be fallen on by the Pilots at the 41-yard line. Good field position to start this drive for River.
Yeah, I think you'd want to pooch it just a little deeper into the second tier, but not always easy to execute.
So the Pilots, they've outscored their opponents on average of 49-10 in the last five contests. They came into those five, I believe, they were like 2-3 or something like that.
Talking with Coach Flannery, he said we played
2-4. Check that.
Played Warren Local and gave up 54 points. He said we played Barnesville and gave up 40. And he said this can't stay the same. This isn't working. So he said they changed defense. They went from a 43, which means there's four down linemen, to what they call 52. They have three down linemen, two ends, and they just got more aggressive defensively. Well, obviously, they didn't. It wasn't very good defense on that play. But he said that really turned their season.
Yeah. Second down and 9 after that short first down run. Going to be a fake handoff and a rollout. Isley looking to pass. And a good job defensively, diving and tipping it out of there. That is Nate Nemeth.
Very good play.
Had his man open, and Nemeth just dove and got a hand on it. Third down and 9 coming up for the Pilots. Check the replay here.
Good pressure.
Yeah, see, he had his man. That's Kramer open. Then Nemeth just cuts in front, dives, and makes the tip. Here's that spread with Isley in the shotgun. Isley sprinting to the near side, looking to pass. He's got his man. What a catch by the tight end once again. Great hands, Brody Longwell, and kept the feet in bounds.
He can be split or at the tight spot, but he does a really nice job. He probably is their overall best receiver, even though he doesn't have the most receptions. And you can see the talent right there, Jared.
It's a really good pass and catch. First and 10 for River at the Berne Union 35-yard line.
Back to the T formation.
First man through, that's Kramer. And he's up to near the 30. Give him a pickup. He is at the 30. Give him a pickup of 5 on the play, second down and 5.
Guys, real quick on this River offense, it's just so impressive that they're able to morph their offense, as you guys were talking about it, you know, to go, you know, two tights with the three backs and then to spread it out. The versatility of their athletes is huge, but also the intelligence and just the ability to do things that they don't practice a whole lot of. Just key to be able to do the things that they do on offense.
It's true.
Here's Kramer again. And up near, they're going to say his knee touchdown right about the 27. Third down and 2 coming up.
Now, Woody Hayes from above would be thrilled watching the T formation.
Isley hands off again, Kramer right up the middle, and he's got the first down. Austin Kramer on the season, 802 yards rushing. Avery Kramer, 432 yards rushing. The twins out of the backfield for the Pilots.
Yeah, and Lolathan, like we talked about, played some quarterback also. He's kind of like their H-back is what they use him as.
Clock rolls down to 2:21 and counting here in this first quarter. 7-6, Berne Union on top in this Division 7, Region 27 playoff matchup. Isley this time gives off to Brody Lolathan. That's who you just mentioned. Give him about 4 on the play.
And guys, throughout the season, Lawlathan has really been kind of their X factor. He's been the big play guy throughout. I know the receivers on the outside make a lot of big plays, but Lawlathan outside of the backfield, coming out of the backfield rather, as a pass catcher and also in the backfield, can be the one that really breaks this game open. So keep an eye on him.
Here's the spread look once again on second down and 6. Lawlathan goes in motion. Quick handoff to Kramer. And he's going to be brought down inside the 20 at about the 17-yard line, third down and 3 coming up.
Yeah, what Marion just said is quite true. I mean, when you look at Lawlathan, he's got 5 rushing touchdowns and he's got 6 receiving touchdowns. Hmm. That's being very, very diverse.
Yeah. Third down and 3. Cool the Pilots. Kramer again, this time he's hit right at the line of scrimmage, but he goes forward and a flag comes flying in. I think he has enough for the first down. We'll have to see what the penalty is. Came from the far side. It was right in the middle of that scrum as they were trying to bring the runner down. So we'll see what the official has to say here.
Five-yard penalty.
So it was the 5-yard variety of face mask and incidental, so it brings him up to the 10-yard line. First and goal from the 10. Under a minute to play in the first quarter.
Yeah, they've just kind of jammed it down their throat here, lining up in the T-backfield here.
Kramer again. Maybe a yard or two on the play. Initial hit by Winkler and Staten. Second and goal from the 8.
Now you know why Coach Flannery wants to keep his offense on the field after a one-play score.
Yeah. Kramer right behind the center, gets inside the 5, down to maybe the 3-yard line. And time is going to run out here in the first quarter as the River Pilots will face a third down and goal from the 3-yard line, trailing 7-6.
Let's give a big shout out to the Standing Stone National Bank. Whether you're ready to tackle a mortgage loan or need cash for home improvements, make Standing Stone Bank the key player in your home or business financial plans. Business to business, neighbor to neighbor, let's grow this town together. Standing Stone Bank, an equal housing lender, member FDIC.
Oh, I showed you River's schedule. Let's take a look at that Berne Union schedule from this 2021 season, unblemished.
Oh, what a fantastic season that the Rockets had. I mean, you know, speaking with Coach Church, you know, his thing is, how are they going to deal with, like tonight, there's going to be some stiff competition, and you might have some adversity. And, you know, I understand that as a coach, you look at it and say, oh, well, they're the favorite, and they're going to – he really didn't feel that way, that they were necessarily the favorite coming into tonight. He said, I have a lot of respect for the teams and the competition they play there. And Coach Flannery had the same thing back to Berne Union. Yeah. He said, wow, they've really gotten it going here the last 2 years. So I think we're in for a great game the rest of the night, the last 3 quarters here.
You know, one thing that's impressive about both of these schools, you look down on the sideline, look at the number of players they have participating.
That's
for
big.
Division 7 schools.
Yeah. I know a lot of kids play both ways, but if you look over there, there's a whole other unit over there that's on the sideline.
Yeah.
And that's, like you said, that's big.
I think Berne might have 2.5 other units on the sideline.
Yeah, they have a great enrollment as far as their football program here.
Third and goal for the Pilots. T formation right behind Isley. They trail it 7-6. Here's Kramer, hit right at the line of scrimmage, and he's not going anywhere.
Good defense.
It's going to bring up a 4th and goal.
Yeah, Dylan Winkler and Nate Nemeth in on that.
Pilots will go for it.
Well, you've kind of pushed your way all the way down the field. Why wouldn't you?
Yeah, why not?
Yeah.
This could be a pivotal point in the guy in the game, guys. Don't need to tell you, but if Burns able to get a stop and then go down and score, this could be huge.
Isley gives off and trying to see who it was that carried it, but he's in for the touchdown.
Yeah, just a straight handoff.
Didn't catch the number. Was that Lolithan? It was Kramer. Austin Kramer for the touchdown. We'll see it here.
You can see here, it's a straight handoff. No messing around, Jared. Straight up.
A good push from that offensive line on the left side of the center.
And right in between the left guard and the center, and the one hole is what they call it.
River will go for two after they missed that first extra point, trying to get it back to a 7-point lead out of the shotgun. Isley with Kramer beside him, looking to pass. He's pressured. Fires one over the middle, and it's caught, but then on the hit, he lost it. So a good job by Berne Union to knock it free. So River scores but can't convert on the two-point conversion. They lead it 12-7 with 11:14 to play in the first half.
See the play here. He has good protection, takes his time, rolls to the left, and tries to throw back across his body.
Yeah, the hit there by Sammy Omna really knocked it loose. If it wasn't for that, I think he might have had it complete.
Big play.
Yes, it was.
Now you score a touchdown and you're ahead. Well, we've seen the Berne Union offense for one play.
Yeah, and only we're 11:14 to play in the first half.
12 minutes and 46 seconds. Berne had it for however long it took Friesner to get down the field for 85 yards.
Friesner will be back deep to receive the kickoff. Kick straight down the middle of the field. A nice booming kick goes into the end zone for a touchback.
Hey, aren't you impressed with how good the field looks?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Week number 12.
I know.
Went down to Trimble last Saturday night for the Fisher Catholic playoff game, and of course, we had a lot of rain leading into that, but, man, it was in bad shape.
Pretty rough, huh?
Speaking of Trimble Tomcats, they lead right now 14-0 over East Knox in the first quarter.
Wow. Is that game at Trimble or?
It's at East Knox.
Okay. East of Mount Vernon.
Yep.
Trip from Gloucester to east side of Mount Vernon, that's a trip.
We'll try to get a Shady Side and Waterford update when we can. That would be the two teams that these two would be looking at. The winner of this game will play the winner of that game. And pressure right now on Nimeth, and he's going to go down in the backfield, brought down at the 15-yard line. Good job defensively there by the Pilots. It was Marshall Beer on the sack.
Yeah, good pressure. Just can't get away, just too many bodies.
There you see 53, Marshall Beer fighting off the block and getting to Nimeth. Brings up a second down and 15 for the Rockets. Omna splits out wide to the near side. Nimeth has Friesner, of course, flanking him to the left. And here is Nimeth on the keeper, gets back up near the original line of scrimmage.
I know the thing that concerned Coach Flannery the most was Nimeth and his running ability. Because in those scramble situations or those passing situations, those are very difficult to defend a lot of times, and he was very, very concerned about it.
Third down and 8 coming up for the Rockets. They do not huddle. They just get the play called in from the sideline. Splitting out to the near side. That's Connor Godenschwager. Nimeth out of that pistol with Friesner behind him. Nemeth, the pass, looking downfield, down the far side, and he overthrew him. He had his man.
Sure did.
That's Sammy Omna. He was wide open. He had burnt his man, but Nemeth overthrows him. Fourth down and eight coming up for the Rockets, and they will be forced to punt back deep in their own territory.
Longwell on the coverage for the Pilots.
Shame, too, guys, because Frisner really did a nice job of picking up the blocker coming in from his running back spot. So had good protection there. Nemeth probably could have held onto the ball for a second or two, possibly had a chance to complete that pass, but he just all overshot it. And surprisingly, we're going to get a punt from the Rockets here.
Not something they've had to do a lot this year.
You know, that's funny you guys mentioned that, because Coach Herbst mentioned that and talked about they've had to work on that this week because they have not punted very much.
It will be Friesner punting. End-over-end punt. Lands exactly at the 50 and takes a Berne Union roll all the way back inside the 35. They'll down it at the 34-yard line. So that's the defensive stop that Coach Flannery needed and wanted from his team. There's the quarterfinal look.
Some very interesting games tonight. Very, very good teams here in the regional, Jared, in Division 7.
I just heard somebody up here in the press box say that Amanda is up on Harvest Prep right now. 7-0. How about that?
That's
the Aces.
That's good news for Amanda.
I want to also say congratulations to Bloom Carroll, who won last night.
They
will
true.
Move on next Friday night. Here's a big run from Kramer, still going all the way up near midfield. And no, yeah, Avery Kramer this time. And he is brought down at the 49.
Really tough running right here. Seems stiff arm, push the guy away, defender carrying people.
Yeah, you're not
going to
bring him
people.
Down by a jersey.
No. And there's 5 extra yards right there with people hanging on.
Stop finally made by Connor Godenschwager. 1st and 10, Pilots. Here's Kramer again. Big push forward there.
Yeah,
and that offensive line is just pushing them forward.
They're getting the job done on the line.
They are.
They're winning that battle right now.
Do see Carter Carpenter checking back in for the Rockets. That might shore up some of those holes there on that defensive side. 6'5", 305. He is a senior. I misread it. I thought he was a junior, but he's a senior. 2nd down and 5 for the Pilots. First man through, short gain this time across the 35.
Yeah, better job of the Rockets linemen getting off blocks right there.
Just got a score update. Waterford leads Shadyside 6-0.
Now that'd be kind
half.
Of a so-called upset. Of course, you never know in high school sports, but Shadyside has had a tradition of some very fine teams in Region 27.
I've read some that Waterford, too, had a slower start, much like River, and have really picked it up since those first few games. 3rd down and 2, under 8 minutes to play in the first half. Isley gives to Kramer, and look at him, still just dragging guys with him.
That's Austin
hanging
that
on
time.
To his jersey.
Alden on the carry.
Well, their numbers 2 and 3, so.
Yeah.
Avery's 2 and Austin is 3, and they're both tough runners.
Mariano, it's not much secret when they line up like that. There's not a lot of secret in what they're doing. So that offensive line, man, they're getting the job done.
Oh, they're absolutely getting the job done, Jared. Marshall Beer had a pancake block for the ages about 3 plays ago that I saw. I mean, they just really push you around. And as Shu was saying, these Kramer boys just run hard every play.
Yeah. Here he comes this time on the outside, getting beyond the tackle. That's the first time we've seen that tonight. The speed from Kramer gets another first down.
He really got to the sideline quick.
And you look at him, he's not a big stocky kid, is he?
No, I mean,
but he runs hard.
6 foot, 180, though. That's pretty solid.
Yeah.
And look at the stiff arm. I mean, he stiff armed.
He got 7-8 more yards after that.
Yeah, Connor Godenschwager, and he got 7 or 8 more yards after the initial contact.
We have an official timeout as it is Godenschwager kind of shaken up. He's going to come off on the near side, limping.
Yeah, you don't like to see anybody, especially at this point in the season.
Right. Trainers will take a look at him. 1st and 10 for River. They lead it 12-7, 7-12 and counting here in this first half. Isley keeps it himself this time. not sure if that was a busted play or it was designed that way.
I think out of their offense, that's a little bit of what they call the quarterback keep, and he just follows the blocker.
Yeah.
He pulls it out and then follows the running back as a blocker. Back in the day, Crooksville High School had some quarterbacks that would do that a lot.
You guys would be shocked to hear this. We did a lot of that when I was with the Bobcats. We called it midline, where the quarterback would just follow the fullback on through and just made a living off of it.
And you had a quarterback that could do it as well.
That's right.
Yeah, Wilson.
Yeah.
That's, oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Marion, how about your Heath Bulldogs?
Oh, yeah, very proud, very proud. They looked really good last night. I was a little nervous when I saw the halftime score. They were down by a couple touchdowns, but they kept it going. I tell you what, they've got a lot of good athletes. They've got a quarterback that has really come into his own this year, and they're really fun to watch. It'll be fun to see. I hope that we get to see them next week in their matchup against Bloom Carroll.
Yeah, it'll be a Bulldog-Bulldog matchup next week.
Yeah, it will.
And we are planning to bring that one to you. We don't know where it'll be yet. That'll be announced tomorrow, I believe.
Yeah.
Could be Lancaster High School.
Could be
maybe
Grove
Canal
Port,
Winchester.
Groveport Canal. You just don't know.
Yeah.
Whoever's willing to host and can accommodate OHSAA.
But how about the job that Coach Bartholomew has done over at Bloom Carroll?
I've told
year
people.
Year after year after year.
I can, for so long, Carroll had some decent teams and okay teams, but he has taken that thing to another level, Jared.
And everybody thought that once, the quarterback a couple years ago graduated, and the kicker, remember they had Schoyck was bombing them from 53 yards, they'll start heading back down. But no, they've just gotten better.
Nah, he's really got it going. They play really hard.
Just got an update from that Waterford game. Shady Side's quarterback left in an ambulance, so that's not good news for
them. No, not at all. That's a dang shame.
Yeah, it is. And he was the backup. So they're down to their third-string quarterback now, Shady Side is. On first and 10 here, the Pilots inside the 10-yard line. Kramer gets up to right. I'm going to spot her right about the 7-8-yard line.
The 7.5-yard line.
Clock inside of 6 minutes to play in this first half. Berne Union has only touched the football for four plays. Well, technically five.
Yes.
Here's a good hard run for the Pilots getting inside the five-yard line. That's going to be close to a first down. And we'll see.
They're just winning the physicality up front, Jared. I mean, it's pretty simple right now. And here they come again. I mean, they're ready.
It is a first down, first and goal. Ball spotted at the 2-yard line.
I know Coach Flannery was impressed with Berne's size, but they're not necessarily just tiny.
Wait a minute. They're bringing the chains back out. Maybe they did not get the first down.
They're going to measure?
Yeah, they are going to measure. They had already laid the chains down, but as most of you probably know, they do have a clip on there, so they do know where to line it up. So no worry that they laid the chains down over on the sideline, and it is a first down.
Well, I think as a coaching staff, you have the opportunity to ask them
to measure.
Huh? Sometimes if it's evident that they are not going to. But that was pretty close right there.
He had to get the index card out to check it.
Yeah.
First and goal, Pilots. They lead it 12-7. And the running back fell down, and Isley just had to keep it himself. Did he get in? He did. Touchdown for the quarterback, Cable Isley.
That's thinking. Just go.
Yeah.
Go straight.
Look at him. Well, I didn't know what to do, so.
I just kept the ball.
Heads up play by the sophomore quarterback, Cable Isley.
You know, he's such a fine athlete, and after this extra point here.
You were telling me on the way down here.
I'll tell you a little bit about some family there.
Going to spread it out here for this two-point attempt. They lead it 18-7. Isley back to pass. And he's got his tight end out there, and it's complete. That is Brody Lolathan. No, check that. That is River Thompson.
Yep.
On the conversion. So makes the score 20-7 River with 5:27 to play in the first half.
Yeah, that's and you'll see here. What a just a nice little move, out move, one-on-one. He's big. River leads the team in receptions. That's his eighth touchdown catch of the year. But anyway, you're talking about Isley. His brother is now a senior at Marietta College. He is the point guard for the basketball team. But when he was at River High School four years ago, he graduated, obviously. He was All-State in football and basketball for, I know, 2 years, maybe even three. But he was a four-year letterman in football, basketball, baseball, and even ran track.
Wow.
What an athlete. Yeah. And this is his younger brother here, Brody.
Huh. Impressive.
Or, I mean, Cable. I'm sorry.
Well, Tim, we're going to find out what this Berne Union Rocket team's made of. This is new territory for them. They have not trailed like this, at least by this much,
no,
in a game all season, down 20-7.
Yeah, and you do find out what you're made of. And you know, Coach Herb's had concerns of this. Like, how are we going to deal with this when people are going to score on you and challenge you? And we'll see.
Yeah, guys, to his credit, Coach Herb, so as those Rockets came off the field on defense just now, just very calm, saying, hey, we're all right, we're going to get back in this, just keep your heads up.
That's great.
Kickoff lands at the 18-yard line. Friesner will take it on a bounce, and still trying to get some yards, and he'll get up inside or across the 20 to about the 24. Listen to this stat, 37 offensive plays for River, four for Berne Union.
So you're lucky to be down 13 is what you're telling me.
Yeah, yeah.
Wow.
First and 10 for the Rockets. They trail it 20-7 with 5:20 to play in the first half.
Yeah. Watch a kickoff return right here. Watch Friesner. Avoids one.
You know, a lot of times on those kicks like that, when it does take a bounce, you know, everybody's kind of freaks out, but it helps the offense.
It does.
The return team, as long as it doesn't take one of those weird bounces.
Yeah, it breaks the normal pace of the coverage team.
Here's Friesner. He'll be brought down right about the 28-yard line. Did I see a flag coming in?
Yeah, I think there's illegal motion.
Okay.
Yeah, they're going to get a legal procedure here on the wideout here, number 43. He was
Friesner
moving.
Yeah, Friesner doubled over right now.
He got hit in a place we don't talk about.
Yeah, I think so. So the penalty on Berne Union will back him up.
Here we go. I didn't see the flag. Yeah, look at
that. Now Friesner, now that he has gone down, will have to come out at least for one play.
Well, he looks like he's really
hurting,
hurt,
isn't he? Yeah, I'm surprised that the trainer hadn't come out. I think the trainer was waiting for the official. See if we can. I don't know.
I didn't see anything there.
Saw the flag come in from the far side. You can hear the conversation from the officials here on the penalty. Friesner is up, and he will make his way to the sideline. After the penalty, it will be second down, or first down, and 15. I think the official left his microphone on. First and 15 for the Rockets.
Sounds Nemeth, like he still had it on.
Yeah,
right?
I think he does still have it on. Nemeth will give off to Luke Schaefer, who comes in to replace Friesner. And Friesner's still trying to work it out on the near side. So Schaefer going to stay in again. But a nice run there by Schaefer, the junior. He picked up 7 yards on that carry. Second down and 8 for the Rockets. Clock rolls down inside of 5 to play in this first half. Nemeth keeps it himself this time, looking for a hole. Big hit there across the 30. Coming up to make that hit was the quarterback, number 4, Cable Isley. But then was very sportsmanlike, helped him up off the ground.
Watch how great this picture is of him putting it in his belly and at the last second taking it out. And nice hard running right there. Here comes Isley in.
Wow.
Kind of finish off the tackle.
Watch him. He'll help him up after he hits him.
Little quarterback on quarterback crime there, guys.
Third down and 2 for the Rockets.
Yeah,
Friesner is back in. It will be Friesner on the carry. Trying to bounce to the outside. He's got the outside, but a good job on the pursuit. He does have the first down. But once again, Cable Isley.
Yeah, good job by Friesner, though, really bouncing that quick, realizing that there wasn't anything there.
Yeah, it was a quick bounce, wasn't it?
It was. He bounced out there and really made a good decision.
I think everything he does is quick, guys. He has the ability to go slow.
Garrett Carpenter now lines up beside Nemeth as he's looking to pass downfield, and he's overthrown his receiver again. Friesner was wide open.
Well, that was a missed assignment by the Pilots.
Yeah. Second pass we've seen him overthrow.
Long ball on the coverage for the Pilots.
Friesner had beat his man.
His body language is showing that he's kind of tired, Jared.
Yeah. Hey, you see our scoreboard sponsor there. I want to say thanks to Buckeye Toyota. They're our first half scoreboard sponsor. Buckeye Toyota would like to wish all of the local athletes best of luck this season. And, of course, coming up winter sports seasons. Buckeye Toyota is your hometown dealer that's here to help. Visit us online at mybuckeyetoyota.com. Second down and 10 coming up for the Rockets. Once again, pistol formation for Berne Union. Nemeth looking to pass once again. And almost intercepted.
Wow.
I thought he had it. That was number 8, Brody Lawlathan. It's going to bring up a third down and 10.
Pilots brings up third down.
He really tried to squeeze that one in there, guys. I mean, I thought that tight end coming across a little covered, but did his best. And I understand why when you got an arm like that, you try to go squeeze those in.
Pretty tight window.
Tim, you mentioned that last play. It looks like he may be winded. I tell you, after that play, pretty much the entire Berne Union team, hands on their hips, they're tired. They have not been in this situation all season. See how they respond. Third down and 10. Nemeth back to pass again. Has time. He's got his man, and it's overthrown. Just a little too high for his intended receiver. This time was number 6. That's Austin Snyder. Or check that. It's Staten. Ian Staten, number 8, not number 6. So a fourth down and a punting situation for the Rockets. Back deep for River will be Brody Lawlathan, who was the man who just about intercepted that last pass.
See the replay here. Just a little high.
It'll be Friesner to punt it away, his second punt of the night. And he's going to keep it. He needs 10, and he's not going to get it.
He got 0, I think, Jared.
Brody
Longwell comes in to make the stop, and a nice job defensively by him. Didn't fool the Pilots. Now, with under 4 minutes to play in the first half, River has a chance. They've got great field position here. I'm not sure that was the time to run that.
You know, it's one of those things, if you don't make it, you don't look too good, and if you do make it, they say, wow.
Well, guys, real quick, I don't know that it was actually called. I think it might be one of those things where Coach Herbst gives Friesner the ability to run it if he so chooses and thinks he can get it, and Coach Herbst looked a little upset after the decision that was made on that one.
Got another timeout on the field brought to you by the Carriage Company. Carriage Company located at 1031 North Memorial Drive in Lancaster. Learn more at carriagecompany.com.
Well, I would say to Marion, have you ever known a player didn't think he was going to make it?
Yeah.
especially a player with that kind of ability.
Absolutely.
Yeah, yeah, that could be.
I was
just going to say, guys, and, you know, these are the things that happens when you have a team that's been leading big over the, you know, the course of the season. They start pressing a little bit when they get down, you know, a couple touchdowns. These things can happen, and I guarantee you right now in that huddle right on the field over there, Coach Church is telling his guys, you guys have to stay poised. We cannot get outside of the things we've done. Heck, with this offense, they could be back in the game in just a couple plays,
you know.
So they just got to keep doing what they've been doing all season.
Glad you brought that up. I was going to ask you, Tim, and, of course, you know, you've got a lot of coaching experience. I've coached, and Marion's played a lot. You know, when you're a team that's really hasn't even been tested all season, you've gone undefeated, you'd never want to lose.
No.
To be tested maybe would have prepared them a little more for this situation they're
well,
in.
Well, absolutely. I agree with that. And
what a catch over on the far sideline. And a great pass by Cable Isley gets him down inside the 10-yard line. That was complete to Lolathan.
Well, in defense of Berne Union, when you looked at their schedule, we'll see the replay here first. Isley put that on the money.
Yes, he did.
And a great job by the receiver just going up and getting it here.
Wow.
Is that Longwell?
That's Lolathan.
Lolathan.
Yeah, what a player.
Down inside the 5. And a touchdown, River. That's number 3. That is Kramer.
Austin Kramer
on the touchdown carry.
But, you know, getting back to your point, Jared, you know, in defense of Coach Herbst, they tried to up the schedule in the early part of the season because he knew they were going to be a little stronger than most of the league people. And, you know, Cool Grove has a very good program. They slipped a little bit. I think they play Caldwell early in the year, and Caldwell's quarterback was out.
Yep.
So, you know, you can't control some of that, and you don't apologize for the league.
Right,
That's your league, and that's what it is. You know, I used to tell our guys, don't apologize. I said, hey, just because you're first doesn't mean you've done something poor. It is what it is.
They did have the one open week on their schedule throughout the season that maybe could have been an opportunity, but
you don't know
what was tried and what wasn't.
Exactly. And sometimes finding games late are in football are absolutely impossible.
Well, right now their backs are against the wall. They are down 27-7 with 3:14 to play in the first half to a very good River Pilot football team.
Well, if they can just get something going here. I mean, they really haven't been able to get anything offensively going in their opportunities. You know, haven't put together any drives or, you know, multiple first downs or anything like that even.
Worthington Christian right now tied up 14-14 with the Fairland Dragons down in Fairland. That's at the end of the first quarter. Of course, Worthington Christian out of the Mid-State League Cardinal as well.
Those are two good football teams. I know Fairland's had a heck of a year.
Yeah.
I mean, I think they played Ironton to an overtime game, and I know how good Ironton
is. Yeah, every year.
Yeah.
Fort Fry leads Nelsonville 6-0 in the first quarter. Amanda Clear Creek over Harvest Prep 7-0 in the first quarter. And that's still haven't gotten an update on that one. Kickoff will be taken by Friesner inside the 10, coming near side. He's got some blockers out here.
Got a wall.
Friesner tried to tiptoe the sideline, and he went out of bounds right about the 25-yard line.
Yeah, he needed about 3 more yards width here of the field. He'd have been gone. But he didn't.
Looks like Amanda right now still leads 7-0 in the second quarter. That game being played at Harvest Prep, which is never an easy place to play.
No, you can see right here he is avoiding tacklers, and they had a little wall.
Yeah,
great block, but he did step out. I mean, he just ran out of room. That was a great block by Godenschwager. Put his man on the ground.
First and 10 Rockets at their own 25-yard line, trailing 27-7 with 3:07 to play in the first half.
You know, in a big thing like this, when you have had a successful group and all of a sudden you get some adversity, you just got to stay calm and poised. And you know, like I said, just come back and do the things that we've been doing and relax.
Carpenter splits out wide to the far side, and a flag comes in. That's going to be false start on Berne Union.
Dead ball. Snap infraction. Offense. 5-yard penalty.
5-yard penalty. Replay first down.
Perfect. Never really understood that one. Snap infraction. Can't they go whenever he, I mean, he's in charge.
Yeah. You'd have to ask somebody else.
It's
Yeah, but if he double clutches with the ball, that's sometimes
true,
where you get. You know, he can't fake the guys out by moving
that's
it around and sneaking. So.
Well, Byron, we used to do that in the backyard.
First and 15 for the Rockets. Here's Friesner.
Oh,
there's
boy.
A big hole there.
Yeah.
And Friesner across the 25 takes a hard hit at about the 27.
Isley put him down on the ground.
And Isley is a player, isn't he? Both sides of the football.
Yeah, you see, it runs in the family.
Well, you and I both, Tim, saw that hole right away and thought, man, he may be off to the races. But give River credit. They closed in and made the stop. Second down and 8 coming up.
Well, both these teams are extremely athletic. I mean, they have kids that can move. They're diverse. And, you know, sometimes when your speed gets matched by someone else, it's a real challenge.
Yeah. Nemeth, back to pass, we'll keep it. Nemeth across the 30, the 35, still on his feet to the 40. Tripped up and stays on his feet. A flag comes in. Could that be a block in the back downfield?
You would hope not if you're a Berne fan.
But the look of Coach Herps, he looks disgusted. So I think this is going against Berne Union. So a good run by Nemeth is going to be wiped off by a holding. I believe they got Ian Staten based on Staten's body language.
Here we got a replay, Jared. We might be able to see it.
Holding. Offense. Number 8. We'll penalize
right
10 yards from the spot of the foul.
Clearly had him.
Yeah.
First down.
Rode him for about 15 yards.
Well, you know what? He did it right.
Yeah.
He held him good.
Yeah. And you always say there's a reason why that run went so far.
I know.
Here's Friesner trying to get outside that tackle. He does so, gets to the 45-yard line. Not much more there. Going to bring up a second down and 5.
Rockets showing a little life offensively here, though. They're just too good of a team offensively to look, you know, as poor as they have here in the first half.
Inside of 2 minutes to play in the half. Look down here. Here's Omna was nobody on him, but he closes in quickly. Here's Friesner getting up across the 50. That's a first down. Berne Union trying to up the tempo here. Try to catch River off guard, and the officials have to stop it. The chain gang was not caught up. And Coach Herps now not happy with the chains. Can't say I blame him. First and 10 at the 50. Nemeth back to pass. He pumps, has time, fires it across the middle. Great job defensively. Once again, Cable Isley.
I know he's done a fine job of quarterback, but heck, I want him to be my safety.
Just a sophomore, too.
You can see here, he makes a good protection. Good job by Nemeth.
Yeah, he had plenty of time, didn't he?
Yeah, he's looking it over. Makes a good throw. But really nice play by the safety.
Yep. Second and 10. Clock stopped at a minute 22. Carpenter getting some instruction from Nemeth. Nemeth again back to pass, has time, fires one down the field. He's got a man, it's caught at the 10-yard line and into the end zone. Touchdown Rockets, that's Sammy Omna.
Wow, big play. Two big plays tonight for the Rockets.
They've been looking for that one all night, and the first couple times he's thrown it long, he's overthrown his man, but this time he hits him right in stride at the 10.
I've not seen a better long pass this year.
Ooh, his knee went down, but of course no replay in high school.
Don't tell him we got the camera, huh? What a throw.
Makes it 27-13. Friesner on to kick the extra point. And it is good. So with 1:11 to play in the first half, Berne Union pulls back to within 2 scores. 27-14. They will get the ball to start the second half. So River doesn't have a lot of time here. A minute and 11 to try to stick another score on the board before halftime.
Well, you know, that's on the 7th reception touchdown this year, but he has 5 return touchdowns. That tells you something about him.
Hey, coming up at halftime, we'll have our halftime band show. You're going to see the show that the Berne Union Marching Rocket Band put on at the Fairfield County Fair. We'll show you that one coming up at halftime. It'll be brought to you by Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, Crematorium Monuments, family-owned and operated since 1889. Check them out at funeralhome.com. The Frank E. Smith Funeral Home, respect for tradition, regard for change. You know, it'll also be brought to you by Fairfield Federal. When it comes to our customers and our community, we go above and beyond to help. Personal or business banking, whatever you need, we take it seriously because we know you do. The difference is clear. Fairfield Federal Savings and Loan specializes in banking that revolves around you. Member FDIC, equal housing lender.
I was going to say, you mentioned the fair. That was only over three weeks ago, and it seems like an eternity.
It does, and it was warm.
This is a nice football night, though.
Pooch kick will be taken at the 40, and he's going backwards, but he's trying to get to the opposite side of the field to try to get some yardage. And he's going to be brought down. He's going to rethink that decision because he lost 5 yards.
Yeah, but he
ran about 50.
I was going to say, he gained a lot laterally.
On the return for River was Clee Mitchell.
You can see here, he's outside the 40. And now he is inside the 40 laterally on the other side. 1 minute even, Jared, to go.
See if they come out in the spread or they stay in that T formation.
You know, why would you change? They've had such a successful half.
Right.
Why would you change? Just run the ball. You've scored 27 points and a half.
Here's Kramer across 45 and up near the 50-yard line. What a run there on first down to get inside of 1 minute to play, 54.1, and they've got 50 yards to pay dirt.
Yeah, that was Austin right there, wasn't it?
I believe so. River does have 2 timeouts left. Now they're going to spread it out. Different look here. They bring a lineman out here. That's Beer. Split out to the near side, along with 2 receivers. A lot of time off the clock, down to 35. Cable Isley going to keep it himself, and he's got another first down up to the 40. And a timeout going to be called by the Pilots with 25.6 to play in the first half.
Kind of a surprising call on that one because it took up a lot of time,
yes,
guys.
It
took a lot of times. I thought maybe they would have ran some sort of trick play. I thought maybe you were going to see a throwback pass or a screen out wide, especially with the lineman being out wide. That would have been the perfect time try a wide receiver screen, but took a lot of time, and they could be in a position to score, so we'll see what happens after this.
Yeah, and the way that they had that set up with the kind of the offset trips over here, it almost did look like it was going to be a halfback pass or a toss one over here to the side and let the receiver throw it.
And they're coming back out in the spread.
25.6 to play. Both teams with 1 timeout left. Pilots lead at 27-14 here in the first half. It's been an entertaining first half. Both teams playing hard. The Rockets, they're back against the wall. We'll see if they can answer and come back in this one. Isley fires one down the side, almost picked off by Omna. He just kind of threw that one up there. He had one man, one receiver out there. That was dangerous.
Well, that's some athletic throw, running left and throwing it off one foot. You know, and he's throwing it 40 yards in the air. That's pretty impressive, but a great play by Sammy Omna.
He did not get a first down on the last play. It's third down and less than one. 18.7 seconds now to play in the first half. Isley out of the shotgun. Again, looking to pass. Fires one down the near side. He's got a man out there. It is caught, and a touchdown for the Pilots. That's number 13, River Thompson, with his second touchdown catch of the night, and a flag comes in late.
Isley's pass complete to Thompson. Good enough for River. Touchdown.
Boy, that was a heave, wasn't it? And hit him in stride.
But it was on target. We've just seen 2 back-to-back long passes that are as impressive as I've seen this year.
So it's on the Rockets.
I think it was because he was in, you know, he's in the end zone.
He
got him good. I'm not sure I've seen that called a lot this year. Not
that?
Saying it's not the right call. Yeah. I just haven't seen it called a lot.
How about that drive? They only had a minute and 11.
Well.
That one took a minute and one.
See, and just when Berne had gained some momentum, you know,
yep.
to Rivers' credit, they came right back and stuck it on them.
Pilots will take a timeout. And Marion, you're right down there on that one. That was an impressive throw from Cable Isley.
It was an impressive throw, guys, and maybe even a better, just impressive show of athleticism from River Thompson. I mean, people forget, you know, because the Kramer kids are running so hard, you got Lalathan. Of course, Isley is a fantastic quarterback, but River Thompson, 6'3", very big, you know, rangy guy, big guy, can run when he gets on the open, just strided past the DB on that one, and just a perfectly thrown ball laid out there, got by the DB, got in the end zone, just a wonderful play, and an amazing opportunity for River to have even more additional momentum than they had going into the second half.
And he's just a junior. I mean, that's... You know, two guys in the backfield, the twins are seniors, and Longwell's a senior, but they've got their quarterback coming back. Cable Isley, just a sophomore. River Thompson's a junior. Marshall Beer on the offensive line, he's just a junior. It's going to be a good team even for a couple years to come.
Well, here's what Coach Flannery also mentioned. Of the basketball players involved at River High School, the top six are playing football.
Wow.
That's pretty impressive.
Yes, it is.
But they're showing their athleticism out here.
They're,
that's for sure.
What you're saying is they might not be on the court for a while.
Yeah.
On the two-point conversion attempt, I don't think he's going to get it. He was stood up right at the line of scrimmage, and they have still not blown the whistle. It was Austin Kramer. He did not get it.
Isley tried to push him in the back, guys. It was a rugby scrum. Total. It was pretty funny there.
33-14, the lead for the River Pilots with 10.5 seconds to play in the first half.
Yeah, Isley's 5'9", 150. I'm not sure how much that. Boy, he just unloaded that ball, didn't he?
He does play bigger than that, though. And maybe
he does.
Tried to get a little bit of the Reggie Bush push, if you guys remember that from several years ago.
Oh, yeah.
And there was that the hit. Yeah, he was 5 yards into the end zone.
Yeah, you just don't see it called. I'm not sure it's the right call. I mean, what's the purpose of it?
So the Rockets will receive the kickoff, and Friesner is on the sideline, so they don't have him to return it. Omna will be back deep. Kick is taken off the ground over on the far side and brought all the way to the near side to about the 26-yard line, and the clock will stop at 1.8. So 1.8 seconds to play in this first half. Rockets trail it 33-14 in this Division 7, Region 27 second-round playoff game. Winner to move on to play the winner of Waterford and Shadyside. At last check, Waterford was leading that one. So we'll see if the Rockets try to heave one down the field or if they're just taking a knee. They do get the ball to start the second half.
I'm not sure I'd take a knee with the talent backs they have in Nemeth.
And a whistle and a flag. And it's on Berne Union. Have we seen any penalties on River tonight?
I don't recall any.
I don't think so.
I think they had a holding call on the first drive, guys, but they got it right back.
Yeah.
So, yeah, it's almost flawless game by them so far.
First and 15. This will be the last play of the first half. Official coming to the side. I think he wants to reset the clock, which it's not going to matter. He wants it had run down to 0.8, and he wanted 1.8. Regardless, it's going to be the last play of the first half.
Yeah, there's nobody that fast to get to the end zone on the other end. Even though we've seen a lot of quickness tonight.
That's true. Nimeth has Luke Schaefer standing behind him and looking to pass. He's flushed out of the pocket. He's going to run it out of bounds.
Yeah, good
and
decision.
And that's how the first half will end. The River Pilots come to Sugar Grove and put up 33 points in the first half to take a 33-14 lead on the Berne Union Rockets. The Rockets will have the ball to start the second half. We're going to take a timeout. When we come back, you're going to be seeing the Berne Union Rocket Marching Band and their show that they put on at the Fairfield County Fair. Stay with us. This is the High School Football Game of the Week.
Presents the Buffalo Wild Wings High School Football Game of the Week. Brought to you by Fairfield Medical Center, Park National Bank, Dagger Law, the Frankie Smith Funeral Home, Fairfield Federal, Standing Stone Bank, Fairfield DD, North Body Shop, Personal Touch Party Rentals and Events, the Edwards Insurance Agency, Buckeye Toyota, The Carriage Company, Huddle Tire and Auto, the Fairfield County Commissioner's Office, South Central Power, Sheridan Funeral Home, and Buckeye Lake Marina.
And welcome back to Berne Union High School, where the Rockets trail 33-14 at halftime against the River Pilots in the second round of the Division 7 Region 27 playoffs. We do want to pass along. We've had some technical issues. However, you will see the second half in its entirety, at least we hope. But we do know that we will be without replays. But other than that, I think we should be good to go, Tim.
I think so. Looking forward to seeing how the Rockets come out this half to try and get back into the ball game against a very good River football team.
It will be Rocket football to start the second half. They will receive the kickoff. And one thing that we talked about down on the truck in the trailer during halftime, we were having a conversation. You know, Friesner took a hit kind of early in that first half and just hasn't really been the same since then. He was shot out of a rocket on that first play from scrimmage that they had, ran 85 yards for a touchdown, then kicked the extra point. And then he got hit. I think it was late in the first quarter, maybe beginning of the second quarter. Just kind of hasn't been the same since then. So we'll have to see. He's standing on the sideline now. Does not seem like he will be out there for the kickoff. Marion, you're right down there. What's it look like?
Yeah, I would echo your comments, Jared. It looks like he's just not. As you said, Berne Union will receive this kickoff, and he's usually the guy that's right out there, has a towel around his neck, as you can see right now.
Yeah.
I don't know what his availability for the remainder of this game would be, but hope that he's okay. I mean, he's a special player, so we'll see what happens.
Yeah, that'll be tough to replace if he's not. They have gone with Luke Schaefer, the 5'9", 175-pound junior, quite a bit in the backfield in his replacement. But also Nate Nemeth may have to take on more of the chore running the football, which he's very capable of doing.
Yeah, he's excellent running the football. But the problem is they just haven't had the ball very long, Jared.
Yeah, that's true.
I'm sure time of possession, if we had that measured, it would be quite a big difference.
Yeah. So just kind of recapping that first half, River took the opening kickoff, and they made a nice, long, time-consuming drive, went down and scored. They missed the extra point. Berne Union comes right back. On their first play from scrimmage, it was an 85-yard. We don't know if it was either a pass, a screen pass, or it was a pitch out. So it could have been a run or a reception. Either way, Friesner went 85 yards for the touchdown and then kicked the extra point, took a 7-6 lead. And then from there, River just continued to go on drive after drive, just methodical. They'd go from a spread sometimes, but they primarily went from that T formation and really just took charge of this game in a hurry.
Yeah, it's just basic football. They're just lining up, making simple blocks, and you have three good backs, a good quarterback, and a good line.
Yeah.
The game's pretty simple sometimes. I think it was 44-18 in plays.
Wow. 44 plays for River, 18 for Berne Union.
And I'm sure that parlays into a really, really big difference in time of possession.
Pilots seem to be a little confused here on the kickoff. They came together and huddled. And now they're back out set to kick off. Zach Hocutt will kick it away. Back deep for the Rockets is Sammy Omna. Good kick by Hocutt, taken at the 11-yard line. Omna gets across the 20, the 25, and finally brought down right about the 30-yard line. And the Berne Union side, at least the fans anyway, yelling for if they want a face mask penalty. But there is not one. So the Rockets go on offense, first and 10, their first possession of this second half, trailing 33-14.
Yeah, big possession here. If they have some success here, can get the ball into the end zone, you're right back in the game.
Winner of this contest will move on to take on the winner of the Shadyside and Waterford game. That is a 3-6 matchup. At last check, Waterford was leading that one. Nemeth takes a snap, going to keep it himself. Trying to find some blocking out there for him, and nice run on first down by Nate Nemeth. It does not appear that Friesner will play in this second half.
Yeah, I mean, he had a little limp there. I don't want to speculate, but sure. I'm not sure whether he has like a groin issue or something.
Second down and two coming up. again. Will keep it himself. This time wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. I guess some extra pushing and shoving after the play. But a... Oh, no, they gave him the first down. Okay, his forward progress got him enough for the first down across the 40. Nemeth will keep it himself again. Had it in the belly and takes it back out. Keeps it, spin across the 50. Still on his feet. All the way down inside the 30-yard line, finally out of bounds. Right about, looks like they're going to mark it right about the 30.
Jared, he has just outstanding footwork. His feet are really good. They're quick. He's got good balance and just an outstanding runner.
He's rushed for 991 yards on the season, 14 yards per carry, 22 touchdowns on the ground.
I know Coach Herbs told me specifically that he would like to see him run more than he was before.
Yeah. There's a pitch out to Luke Schaefer, and Schaefer wrestled down behind the line of scrimmage.
Yeah, River Thompson made a really good play and read on that, Jared.
Second and 12. Rockets never do really huddle. They just get the, they turn and get the play from the sideline. Nemeth hands it off to Schaefer up the middle, across the 30. Good little run there by Luke Schaefer.
Nice job by the line to create an opportunity for him to get there.
Brings up a third down and 8. This time has right behind or beside him Garrett Carpenter, the fullback. Nemeth will keep it himself. Nice move to kick it outside, trying to get enough yardage for a first down. And just dragged down by an arm on the tackle. That's 81, Brody Longwell.
He tried to give him a stiff arm, but
he grabbed the arm.
Yeah, Longwell's arms are a little longer, so he can reach across even the stiff arm and get him.
And we have a whistle and a player getting up slow for River. That's number 67, Mason Randall.
Looks like it may be a cramping issue there, guys, for Randall.
So coming in to replace Randall will be Cooper Cordry. 5'10", 250-pound sophomore is Cooper. Fourth down and 5 upcoming for the Rockets. They trail at 33-14, under 9 minutes to play in the third quarter.
Countdowns, you can check the back, Judge.
Yeah, they're going to have to call a timeout or they're going to get a delay of game. And it is going to be a delay of game. They were taking a long time to get that play called.
Fence, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Makes it fourth and 10 now.
Yeah, guys,
Herb just looks all out of sorts, don't they, Marion?
Yeah, I think Coach Herbs might have thought that there was an injury timeout on that last
one.
He's talking to the official right now, and you could see he took his time when he was talking to Nemeth when he came to the sideline. I think he thought that there was a stoppage of play, but the whole time the play clock was running.
Interesting. Fourth and 10. Ball spotted at the 30. Still directing traffic. Fires across the field. Wide open. This one might go for 6. It's Connor Godenschwager into the end zone for the touchdown.
Wow. That was a little backyard, you know, creativity right there.
Sometimes it's better to be lucky than good, guys.
I hear you. Gottenschwager was just over here on the far side, like, hey, there's nobody with me.
Why, he showed his speed.
Throw it over
too,
here.
Three-minute, 45-second drive. That's what they needed to get back in the game, Jared.
Dylan Winkler will attempt the extra point. Remember, that's usually Bray Friesner, who's out of the game. So the left footer puts it up, and good.
At the top row of the bleachers in the end zone right
there. Makes it 33-21 with 8:15 to play in this third quarter.
Yeah, the real challenge comes now because they had no success at stopping River in the first half of all defensively. Now here comes the challenge, and if they can get some stops or put some pressure on River, they can get back into the game. But River's extremely well coached and was very effective in the first half.
Checking some scores in the third quarter. Amanda Clear Creek continues to lead Harvest Prep 10-6 at Harvest Prep in a, it's a Division 5 matchup,
yes,
isn't it? So Amanda kind of stubbed their toe in week 10 of the regular season, losing to Fairfield Union at home, which hasn't happened in a long time. And then they've done a nice job in the playoffs.
Well, an interesting thing about that, and talking to some people, the quarterback for Fairfield Union, I can't recall his name off the top of my head, he rushed the ball 50 times.
Oh, my goodness. Well, I remember the game we did out there. It was just direct snap. I'm keeping it.
He had 50 rushes against Amanda.
Winkler, high kick. This is dangerous. And it's taken by River. It was number 5 on the return, Lucas Dennis. Boy, that could have been in favor of Berne Union there. That real high kick like that?
Yeah, that's a free ball. If they just had a little more speed on the coverage, they might have gotten there at the same time.
Yeah, and Dennis has got to know on that one, guys, he can fair catch that ball. When it's up in the air like that, he can call for a fair catch. So he might, for his own safety next time, if that ever happens again, he needs to do that.
So here come the Pilots, first and 10, their first touch of the football in this second half. Isley gives off to his main target, Austin Kramer, and he is wrapped up in the backfield for a loss. Or Avery Kramer. They'll spot him at the 38, so it's a loss of 2, second down and 12. .44 and counting here on the running third quarter clock. Isley looking to pass. Over the middle. Did he catch that?
I thought it hit the ground.
They're saying it's incomplete.
Yeah, good call.
Isley slow getting up in the backfield. He was hit after he threw and slow to get up. Brings up a third down and 12 for River.
Like I said, I really feel this is where the key is for Berne. They had almost zero stops in the first half, Jared.
Yeah, you're right.
And you know, you got to pick the defense up. Got to get more aggressive. And you know, you may have to gamble some. They're coming to the full house.
Isley hits his man at the 50 and a first down for the Pilots. That's Brody Lollathan.
Wow, he's really accurate when he's on the move like that. Yeah, he is.
Rolling out to his left, throwing it on the run.
You know, it looks like the old run and shoot offense. He just is so smooth.
Yeah, it's too bad we don't have Brody play, guys. That was a rope that he threw right there. Again, rolling to his left, as you guys said. Just continues to impress out here, Isley.
Yeah, if you missed right at the beginning of the second half, I mentioned that we have had some technical issues at halftime, so we are without replay here in the second half as a flag comes flying in there on that run. I think this one might be on River as the official is pointing at the sticks, the chain gang, to stay put.
Personal foul, targeting.
Oh, wow.
personal foul. Helmet to helmet contact.
I do wish we had replay now so we could see this.
Yeah.
I definitely didn't see it.
Illegal helmet contact. Defense number 12 will penalize 15 yards. First down.
And that's on Nate Nimitz.
That's a 15-yard penalty against Hawkins.
Yeah, they don't call targeting at this level. That's
right.
My fault. But so used to seeing it on Saturdays and
yeah.
Sundays, you
yeah.
know.
And now another player coming jogging off for Berne Union. L.J. Blevins will go in to replace Garrett Carpenter. But after the 15-yard penalty, it's a first down for River. Isley keeps it himself, fakes the pitch out, gets down inside the 15-yard line, takes a hit, but gets a first down.
He's a pretty tough cookie.
He is.
He pops right back up.
That didn't look much different from the hit that Nemeth just had. So that some of those targeting. And you know, just quick, guys, I feel so bad for the defense on certain one of those because what can you do? You got a guy that's running the ball as hard as Kramer has been
yeah.
running all day. You got to come up and lay a wall up on him. And, you know, sometimes some of those targeting calls, you just hate to see them.
Yeah, I agree. I can't remember what game it was I was watching last week, but they called one of those. And what had happened was the running back actually ducked his head and made contact, but they called it on the defensive man.
Yeah.
Short gain there for River.
Short gain on the play, brings up second down.
Second and 9 coming up. Ball spotted right about the 12-yard line. River trying to answer after that first score of the second half for Berne Union to cut it to 33-21, 6-12 and counting here in this third quarter. Isley this time wrestled down, slung down, number 60 for the Rockets, or number 50, James Ashton.
They spotted it 6 yards ahead where he landed. Big play for the Rockets right here, defensively.
Third down and 13. They can get a first down, looks like right about the 4-yard line.
I got a comment. Our picture is so clear tonight, Jared. It's beautiful.
Yeah, it is. Isley rolling out. This is where he's dangerous. Nobody there. Good coverage downfield by the Rockets and forces him out of bounds behind the line of scrimmage.
Well, good job by Isley, too. Don't throw something up in
right.
the air. And you're in scoring position. Sometimes a run out of bounds or an incompletion is better than taking a risk here.
Yep. It's at fourth down and 13 for the Pilots. Ball spotted at the 16-yard line. Rockets could use a stop right here. Maddox Mozina splits out wide to the bottom. To the right side, Isley looking to pass, has pressure, going to tuck it in and run. Isley, he's knocked down. I don't think he got the first down. Needed to get to about the 4, and he didn't get
short. It. Got it about the 6.
Not a bad decision by him. There was nobody open, and he saw green grass in front of him, but a good job by the Rockets to close in.
Yep. Shut down the lane, the running lane.
Now the Rockets will be backed up, but they've got the ball after the turnover on downs, trailing 33-21, 5:15 to play in the third. Nemeth will split Omna out wide to the near sideline. Over on the far sideline, it's Godenschwager. Nemeth will hand it off right up the middle to Schaefer. Not much there. Luke Schaefer, the 5'9", 175-pound junior.
Really good job by Beer right there. He really fought off a blocker, Jared. Went left to right, made a great tackle.
Yeah, he's played really well.
He has.
Marshall Beer, the junior. plays offensive line and defensive line.
He's a good football player.
He is. Number 53 for River. They give him a loss on that last play of two, so second down and 12. Nimmeth, the pass out of his end zone, fires one down the middle of the field and overthrows his intended receiver. That was Sammy Omna, who gives a shove to the defender after the play. That's Isley on the receiving end of that.
People really starting to react about everything right now. You just settle down.
Yeah. Brings up a third down and long for Berne Union. Fakes the handoff to Schaefer, has pressure in the end zone, hits his intended receiver, and he's brought down at about the 15-yard line. It's going to be short of a first down by about a yard or two. Staten on the receiving end for the Rockets.
They're having a little trouble with River Thompson out here on the right. He's got some length, and he rushes from his defensive end spot, and just, you know, he blocks your view. He's got some size, yeah, and he's very, very active.
Listed at 6'3". He looks a little bigger than that.
Yeah, you can see number 13 there. We know one thing, he's not superstitious.
Right. Berne going to go for it right here. Fourth down and one on their own 16-yard line. Nimmeth out of the gun, keeps it himself, and he has the first down, I believe. Gets up near the 20. Only needed to get to about the 17, so he's got the first down.
Yeah, really good job by the middle of the Berne Union offensive line. They created that space for him.
Guys, it'll be interesting to see Coach Hertz call this game the rest of the way with Frazier obviously not coming back in the game.
Right.
You know, it just changed the whole dynamic of, you know, how you run your offense and with, you know, I'm sorry, just being the dynamic player that Nimmeth is and running the football. It'll be interesting to see how much they want to, you know, get him involved as far as a runner.
Yep. And here he is up the middle to about the 20. Short gain on the play.
They've already shown in this half they're going to invest in him running the football. Yeah. And why not?
Clock rolls down to 3.5 minutes to play in the third quarter. Score is 33-21. River on top of Berne Union in the third quarter of this Region 27, Division 7 playoff matchup. Nimmeth rolls out to the near side, has a little bit of pressure, fires over the middle. It's complete to the 30-yard line, about the 31-yard line. Good coverage, but a nice pass right in there to Omna.
Yeah, you know who's on the good coverage again. Good throw, good catch there.
Nimmeth kept it in the belly a long time and then kept it himself, and he jumped there, and that's dangerous. He took a hit at the 35.
Like I said, they've run to the left side here quite a bit.
Second down and seven coming up for the Rockets. Harvest Prep now has gone ahead of Amanda 21-10, 3 minutes. Second and seven. Pistol formation for Nimmeth with Schaefer right behind him. Here is Schaefer on the carry. Boy, what a job by Kramer on the tackle. It looked like Schaefer had a little bit of room over here on the side, but Kramer came from
his linebacker spot.
Yeah, man. He came in there quick.
Yeah, he shot the gap. He saw the hole. You know, as we said before the game, they play a 52, but they move those. You know, some people say, well, it's a 34, but it's really a 52. They move those two ends up tight.
Third and eight upcoming for the Rockets. Inside of 2 minutes to play in the third quarter.
There's only three down linemen, but the two kids standing on the ends, if you look at the size of them, Jared, they're both those defensive ends are good size athletes.
Nemeth dumps it over the middle, almost intercepted, and he was hit after the pass. Coming in there to put a hit on him is Maddox Mazzina, and it's going to bring up a fourth down and eight. They converted already once on a fourth, but that was fourth and one. This fourth and eight, that's a little tougher, so they're going to bring the punt team out.
I like this call with, you know, minute 16 in the quarter, and you still have a whole quarter to play. You just can't give them the ball at your 35-yard line.
And she, you just called it with Mozina coming in there so quickly. That's the advantage of running this type of defense, right? You know, you got guys on the corner with that kind of closing speed that can get to the quarterback that quickly. Even when you have a three-step drop or a short pass like that, he's still right on top of the quarterback.
Lawlethan back to receive the punt, almost blocked. Lawlethan will let it bounce, takes a bounce at the 35, and we down right about the 32-yard line. So the Pilots go back on offense with 106 to play in the third, leading 33-21.
And let's say thanks to Buffalo Wild Wings. Thanks to Larry Tipton and the crew for great food, great service, and the best sports viewing in town. It's all at Buffalo Wild Wings in the Plaza Shopping Center on North Memorial Drive in Lancaster.
So first and 10 for the Pilots.
Again, this is the real challenge for the Rockets, to see if they can slow this offense again.
Isley fakes the handoff, keeps it himself, weaving his way up through the middle of the field. Pick up about eight on the play. Isley, he's been impressive tonight, both offensively and defensively.
Yeah, you know, it doesn't matter what grade you're in, even though he's only a sophomore, he has had a very, very solid game.
Yes, he has. Gives it off to Kramer. Kramer has the first down up near midfield. And that will probably be the last play of this third quarter.
Yeah, you would hardly make a mistake if you say you gave it to Kramer. That's two out of the three choices back there.
That's true. And clock's going to roll down, and that will end the third quarter with only one score in the quarter, and that's being Berne Union right off the bat out of their first possession of the second half. They drive down and score to cut it to within 33-21 as we head into the final quarter of play here from Berne Union.
Well, you know, we talked a lot before the game of, you know, for some people may not be totally sure where is Hannibal and where is River. Well, they're part of the Ohio Valley Athletic Conference, and Jared, that conference was started in 1943. I mean, that's impressive.
Yeah.
You know, we talked about that earlier. 50 teams in that Ohio Valley Athletic Conference.
Wow.
Serves a lot of schools and provides a lot of competition there. Very, very impressive. Obviously, Berne Union plays here in the Mid-State League Cardinal, which is a very, very fun league and division to play in also. So, you know, both these teams representing their leagues very well.
And if you weren't with us early in this game, in the pregame, we talked about Coach Mike Flannery, who's in his 19th season at River, 39th overall coaching, and you mentioned that his dad started the football program at River High School.
In 1957.
Wow. And the field is named after him.
Yes.
What an honor that has to be for Coach Flannery to coach in the program his father started on the field that's named after his father.
I just wowed.
Yeah.
I didn't know what else to say. That's some story.
Yes, it is. Good stop there by the Rockets on the opening play of the fourth quarter. Second down and 10.
And with that being said, I want to thank both coaches. They spent some time speaking with me and sharing some things, and I really appreciate that. That just allows us to give our viewers that much more information and knowledge about what's going on. Makes our broadcast totally that much better.
Yes, it does. So you were talking about that 50 teams in the OVAC after this play. I'm going to talk about the breakdown because people are probably thinking, how do you have 50 teams? They don't play everybody.
No.
But it's broken out into several different divisions.
It
right?
is. They run from A, which is your smallest, to 5A now. Hannibal is considered a double A team, 2A, which is next to the small. There's even teams smaller as, as A's. But they group them, and they play, you know, similar competition. It's in northwestern West Virginia and southeastern Ohio. And as we talked earlier, Monroe County itself and the Switzerland of Ohio's local school district has three high schools in their district.
Big third down right here. Third down and 8 for the Pilots. Isley rolling to pass. That's where he's been so good tonight, and it's caught. What a job over there on the far sideline. That is Lolathan, or Thompson, River Thompson again, tiptoed the sidelines after making a nice catch. A big gain on the play for the Pilots.
Marion talked about him earlier, you know, and he is their leading receiver. But you know what's amazing to me? I look at him, and he's playing defensive end on defense, and he's a wide receiver on offense. That's pretty impressive.
He's got good hands.
He sure does. And what a throw by Isley.
And Berne Union was forced to call a timeout there. They had a player trying to get off the field, and just they had to call a timeout, or they were going to get a penalty there. And that's unfortunate for Coach Herbst and his crew to have to waste a timeout this early in the fourth quarter. They trail at 33-21. Want to say thanks to our timeout sponsor, which is the Carriage Company, located at 1031 North Memorial Drive in Lancaster. Learn more at carriagecompany.com. Also, our second half scoreboard sponsor is Buckeye Lake Marina. If you're looking for a new boat, a great pre-owned watercraft, or a place to get parts for your boat, Buckeye Lake Marina has it all. More information can be found at buckeyelakemarina.com. Winner of this game moves on to take on the winner of Waterford and Shadyside next week.
Had a place to be determined.
Yeah. Yeah, first two rounds always go to the better seed, and then, or at least it has been the last couple of years, and then we go to a neutral site.
Well, with including the 16 teams in the regions now, you know, I mean, it just makes an extra round.
Just got a score update. Shadyside leads that one 20-13 in the fourth quarter over Waterford. Shadyside, the better seed, they are the three seed, Waterford the sixth seed, and Shadyside playing with what we believe is their third-string quarterback.
Backup.
Yeah. How about this score? Worthington Christian now trails 35-14. That game once was tied 14-14. Fairland having a good second half to go up 35-14 on Worthington Christian.
Like I said earlier, they've had a heck of a season. You know, you talk about if River wins this game and they play Shadyside, that was a 14-12 game this season.
Wow.
That Shadyside won. So that'll be a dogfight.
Well, they made the announcement of the score of that game earlier tonight in the first half, and there was a big roar. That was when Waterford was leading, and there was a big roar from the opposite side of the field.
I'm sure there's
But I bet you they would like to have a rematch, though.
Yeah, I'm sure. There's a little competitive spirit there.
First and goal, ball spotted at the 12-yard line for the Pilots. Isley keeps it himself right up the middle. Isley to the 5, to the goal line, touchdown. Ball comes loose, but the official already waved it a touchdown for the Pilots.
That little quarterback draw right there. He just paused for a moment, froze the defense, and then kind of danced his way to the end zone, really, Jared.
Coach Herbst wants an explanation. He saw the ball come out, but the official had already scored a touchdown. Kick is up, and it is good. So the Pilots lead it now 40-21 with 10:11 to play in the ball game.
Just such a fine offensive show by River tonight.
Yes, it has been.
I think the Rockets are playing hard. They're giving it all they got. They just don't have any answers.
See what they can come back with. They're going to have to up the tempo and probably pass quite a bit here to try to get it down the field in a hurry.
Yeah, you're going to have Nemeth run or throw it one way or the other. You know, you're a little bit you lost some of your options offensively, so you know you're just going to have to put it on Nate Nemeth's shoulders and see what he can get done.
Omno will be back to receive the kick, back deep. Nice chill in the air tonight here in Sugar Grove.
Back deep for the Rockets.
Cooled down quite a bit over the last week. I understand we're supposed to get back up into the 60s this week, though.
Yeah, good week. You get your outdoor stuff cleaned up. That's what I've been working on. And week after that, you know it's gonna drop. Right?
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, when they start telling you there's this many weeks to Christmas, you know.
Kick is taken at the 12-yard line by Omna.
He's got two return touchdowns this year on kickoffs.
And he lost the football. And the River Pilots have it. Omna had it stripped out of there, and the Pilots jump on it. Big turnover right there.
Hey, you got to keep playing. If you're the team that's behind, you got to keep fighting here. You never know what could happen.
I want to say thanks to all those watching live on Facebook and YouTube. Got a lot of folks tuning in from all over the place. Again, we apologize that we are without some of our usual graphics and replays and stuff. The second half, we had some technical issues right as we were going to halftime. Maybe it's the cold tonight.
Maybe.
Got to the machinery.
They certainly didn't ask you or I to fix it.
Or me.
We wouldn't be on the air at all.
That's so true.
Here's a handoff to Kramer. Austin Kramer. Short gain on the play. Probably going to see quite a bit of just the running game right now. Run this clock for the Pilots as they lead it 40-21 with 9:46 and counting here in the fourth quarter. Again, at last check, Shadyside up on Waterford. 20-13. That's who will be waiting the winner of this game. We will be back on the air with you, hopefully anyway, next Friday night, as we will have a Bulldog battle. The Bloom Carroll Bulldogs will take on the Heath Bulldogs in Division 4 at a place to be determined. We will hopefully have that one for you next Friday night. Here's a pitch. Little lateral, forward lateral to, again, number 13. River Thompson's had himself a game tonight. There's a late flag coming in.
You know, that's considered a pass, Jared, when they do that, for yardage-wise and statistics. I really like the design of that play, though. It looked like they were running an option, and River Thompson came back and cut underneath.
Especially with the reverse out of the quarterback on that one. Gives the linebackers just a little hesitation that may stop their pursuit on that as well. Just a very nifty-looking play.
Yeah, good point.
It's an unsportsmanlike conduct penalty on Berne Union. That'll be 15 yards and a first down for River. This is when stuff can go haywire for a team that hasn't faced much adversity like this all year. So they try to keep it in check here. And credit Coach Herps for getting the player off the field in a hurry that committed that penalty.
Absolutely.
So first and 10 for the Rocket or the Pilots, 8:51 and counting here in the fourth quarter. They lead it 40-21 over the 2 seed in this Division 7 Region 27. Here's Kramer right up the middle. Man, he is hard to bring down. Look at him. He's still going.
Wow.
All the way up to about the 6-yard line. Snyder on the stop for the Rockets.
Which Kramer was it?
That's number 3. That is Austin Kramer.
Yeah, Austin's their leading rusher anyway.
And guys, I'm sorry, real quick. Austin Kramer, 6 foot, 180 pounds, runs like he's about 240 pounds.
He does,
pounds.
Yeah.
I mean, he runs so hard, guys. Never goes down by the first tackle, which, again, is the quintessential trademark of a good running back. It takes 2-3 guys to bring him down, runs through the first tackler, just impressive all night.
He has run for 802 yards on the season, 6.9 per carry, 16 touchdowns. while his twin brother has run for 435 yards and two touchdowns. That's 7.6. So I guess his brother could say, hey, you might have run for more yards, but I've got a better yards per carry average than you. Because you can bet that there's, you know, there's some battles going on at home, right?
Oh, I'm sure. And you know what? As a coach, too, you could switch their number some night. They might have a opposing team might be mixed up a little bit.
That's true. That's true. We have a timeout on the field with 8:19 to play in the game. 40-21. River leads Berne Union.
There we are.
It's a cold night here in Sugar Grove, but the fans still came out to support their Rockets. And, of course, I've got to say, give a shout-out to J.D. Latore and the Rocket Band. Always do a great job. A lot of people come and support them as well. They had a pregame show and a halftime show tonight. That is some band program that he's got going on down here in Sugar Grove. They go to competitions every weekend, and they compete against bands that are bigger than them, and they win grand champion about every weekend. So great job. Congratulations to them on a successful season. Second down and 4 for the Pilots inside the 10-yard line. Isley's had a fantastic game tonight. He hands it off and a touchdown, almost untouched for number 8. That's Brody Lolathan.
They just got a whole offensive unit of weapons.
46-21 now. They're pouring it on here with 8:14 to go in the game. On to kick the extra point for the Pilots is Zach Hocutt, 5'10", 160-pound senior. Shu, you mentioned that he's one of the best in their area, right?
Yeah, things I had read in the media, and he just has a really, really, people have a really good high opinion of him.
And we jinxed him.
I'm glad he wasn't shooting a foul shot.
We're good at that, too, aren't we?
Oh, my. We're sorry.
Yeah. He'll be happy that we're not doing his game next weekend. 46-21 the score with 8:14 to play in regulation here from Sugar Grove. Berne Union will go back on offense. At this point, it's kind of a test of wills, right? I mean, the chances of coming back are pretty slim, but you want them to play hard till the final whistle.
Absolutely. The one thing you have to learn in as an athlete and hopefully coaches are teaching it, you play to the maximum ability of your effort every play, regardless of whether you're going to win the game. Yeah. There are some kids out here that are going to be on the team now. Really? And it's expected that you play when you come out all four quarters.
Including Nate Nemeth, who's
yes,
a junior.
Yes, exactly. And he will. Yeah, you can be disappointed, but you need to play every play because
right.
There are no guarantees you get another one.
Yeah. Omno will be back to receive the kickoff. He's at his, standing right about his 10-yard line off the foot of Hocutt.
Boy, he put a leg into that.
Yes, he did. And that's going to be a touchback. I believe that's the second one he's kicked tonight.
I'm telling you, that's a weapon. When you can force touchbacks off your, you know, to kick off, I mean, I think I've told you this before, but my neighbor coaches football, and they've done a study on how many high school teams are able to drive the ball further than 70 yards and score, and the percentage is really low. And it's such a weapon.
Yeah, it is.
You know, we've seen over the years, you talked about Sharkey from Carroll,
Vio at Fisher Catholic.
Yes.
It's a good one as well.
Yes. And in the past, can't remember his name from Hilliard Davidson, he just he could dominate the game.
J.J. Vio missed a 45-yarder by about a yard last week at Trimble. And the unfortunate thing about that is there was a 15-yard penalty right before it. So
wow.
He would have had it. Here is a nice run by Luke Schaefer. First down run all the way out across the 30-yard line.
Really good hole right there. Coming right at us.
Speaking of people who will be back next year, Luke Schaefer, the junior.
He looks good.
Yes, he does. Five you know, foot 175 pounds out of the backfield.
You know, you talk about Berne, and the same thing with the pilots. I mean, you're ahead. Don't get lackadaisical.
Right.
That's not going to do you any good next week. You've got to play at a high level all the time.
And try to stay healthy here at the end of this contest. Here's Omna, and a good job defensively by the pilots. As Omna will just trying to stay up. Where are they going to spot that?
Wherever they determined that the forward progress was.
Lost yardage on it.
Well, he's fighting for yards, though.
Yeah.
And you like that.
Yeah.
You do. You like that in your players when you see that.
Second down and about 17 here. Clock rolls down inside of 7 minutes to play in the contest. 46-21. River leads. And we've got a whistle and a timeout. Coach Herb's going to take one. Try to get some things situated here on the offensive side of the football. It's been a good season for this Rocket team, undefeated up to this point. They faced a buzzsaw here tonight in the River Pilots. This is a good football team. We mentioned earlier that they started the season, I believe it was 2-4.
Yeah.
And then they've reeled off 5 in a row.
Well, you lost the opening game to Bel Air, which is all, they're still in the play. I think they're 10-1 right now, Jared. So, you know, you're not playing chopped liver there.
Yeah.
And then they played Warren, and Barnesville still in. And Warren did not have the season they wanted, but they're like three times bigger. And he said they just had a hard time defensively.
Yeah.
And that's when they changed and went to the 52 defense. And they're very impressive defensively.
I want to get you and Marion's thoughts on the 16-team playoff, the expansion that they've gone to this year in every division. What are your thoughts on that? I mean, I can remember it was 4 a long time ago. Then it went to 8.
Yeah.
And then last year, I think it went to 12. And then last year it went to everybody because of COVID. And now we're at 16. Marion, what do you think?
Well, I think when you talk about when you said it was 4 years ago, that was really unfortunate.
Yeah.
You saw a lot of teams go 9-1, some
yeah.
even 10-0
and
not
yeah.
make the playoffs. So that was something. When they expanded it to 8, that was good because you saw less of that.
Right.
And teams at least, you know, were able to make it in if they had that kind of record, as we see Nemeth go out of bounds there. But then when you talk about the 16-team expansion, I think that's been really cool because it's allowed, you know, teams that were, you know, having a, you know, 500 season
sure.
or something like that to still have something to really, really play for to try to get that playoff berth. So what it did, I think it enhanced the regular season even that much for so many more teams. So I think overall it's been a good thing.
I think maybe where they may need to revamp it, though, is in Division One. You've got some divisions there where only one or two teams were left out.
You've got
0-10 teams or 1-9 teams getting in.
I think if they go back to what they did before where they combined two regions in Division 1, then take the top 16.
Then it's fine.
If you look at the Division 1 results from last week, you'll see very lopsided scores in that first round. But I will say this, probably the most competitive scores here in the second round overall. You know, I'm kind of mixed on it in some way. I like all kids having positive experience in athletics, but 12 I thought would maybe even reward those top 4, let them heal, get a week off and recover.
Mm-hmm.
I thought that might make it a little more competitive. You go to 12 teams, but I do like the expansion of it. I think kids, you know, putting a lot of time and effort in. And who cares if they play another game?
Right.
As far as, you know, that's how I am with it. You know, they say, well, you can't compare football though, to basketball and baseball.
But as a basketball coach, I mean, you're looking at, and of course it's minimal teams, but you're looking at December 4th for a state championship in football.
I know.
Ineligible downfield offense.
That
penalty is declined. Personal foul. Offense will penalize half the distance. Third down.
That penalty will be assessed.
So as a basketball coach, I mean, you got to be thinking, man.
You know, like
for this River team, you mentioned that
the top six kids,
top
are on the
six
football.
Kids, are play basketball.
But when you're in those situations, and I was in one,
yeah,
That was actually in a couple where teams would advance. You just have to understand that. I always like the kids playing multiple sports and being in it. The thing you have to be conscious of is how you then, the kids that aren't involved, and then you do have legal practice time, how you approach that with them.
Right.
And, you know, when it first happened to me, Jared, I talked to the people that had been in that situation, people at Newark Catholic, people at Columbus DeSales, because they were in it almost every year.
Right.
And they gave me some great tips and advice in how to deal with it.
There's Nemeth on the carry. A good run on by Nemeth after a big loss for penalties. But it will bring up a fourth down and long for the Rockets. Fourth down.
But, you know, it's just unfortunate being the second sport.
Yeah.
You know.
But then again, in the springtime, as a baseball coach,
you're the third
sport.
If you've
got a basketball team, that goes a long way.
It happens, and you just got to deal with it.
Yeah.
And you know what? My policy used to always be, if you did the few things that we asked you to do in the off season, we weren't going to dominate your summer. Just do the few things we ask.
Sure.
You'll be fine.
But I 100% agree with you. I want kids playing all sports.
Oh, yeah. I want kids that are used to competition, being coached, and how to deal with some things. And the one thing I've always said about football is you're going to get knocked on your can once in a while, and you got to learn to get up.
Nemeth's pass is intercepted at the 32-yard line, and look who it is. It is Avery Kramer.
Well, they're the two linebackers, and they had really deep drops that time. Avery and Austin are there.
So he's going to say to his brother, Austin, hey, you might have had a good game on the ground, but I had the interception.
Absolutely.
So River will take over first and 10, already leading at 46-21 with 6:04 to play in the contest. First and 10 at the 34,
you know, one
or
more,
24.
One more thought on that, Jared. I always found that my kids, or the kids that were playing a second sport, when they were involved in the sport and the activity and they had organization, they did better in the classroom also.
Yeah.
Because they knew how to budget their time.
First and 10 for the Pilots. Isley gives it off. He keeps it himself. A little screen pass out to the right side to Lolathan. And out of bounds near first down yardage. Hey, I want to go to Marion for a second. I was watching the last the Fisher and Berne game. Of course, I was in attendance, but I watched it back. I love watching, and I saw a basketball highlight of our man Marion, and I think the comparison was to LeBron James.
Yeah, I have our own Josh Meschley to thank for that. Again, I'll take that to the grave that I'm in the same class as LeBron, no matter what anybody else says. But, yeah, no, I actually didn't have a chance to see it, obviously being down on the field when it was playing, so I didn't know what was going on. So I played it back when the next day, and I thought, why didn't you dunk that?
I
was right there. Absolutely. I was like, why didn't you dunk the ball? So
he was feeling sorry for me, I think.
Yeah. So we obviously, Marion, we know you as our as the football guy, playing football at Ohio University. But man, the basketball skills look good.
I play with a lot of athleticism, not so much skill all the time. Streaky shooter, not the best ball handler, as I'm sure Shu will tell you.
Did you coach against him?
Yeah.
Did yeah.
Okay. Well, I will tell you this. In all honesty, you had to account for Marion, though, in the game. He was a factor in the game. And you did. You had to account for you.
Yeah.
And there are players over the years, Marion, that we didn't account for. And I'm not going to name anything.
And for me, it's probably more defensively than offensively because I, used to block a lot of shots. That was really my thing more than offense. But, a lot of fun times. Great time. Basketball really was my first love.
I
stopped growing. I was just sure. My uncle's 6'4". I thought I could maybe get to 6'5", 6'6". It wasn't in the card, so I stuck to football.
I think it worked out well for you.
Yeah, it worked okay.
Third down and 5 coming up for the Pilots. No, it'll be third down. 4:46 and counting here in this fourth quarter. Pilots lead it 46-21. Those of you who may be joining us from out of our normal viewing area, we're talking with our sideline reporter Marion Royster, who is an Ohio Bobcat alum, was a good running back for the Bobcats. And if you heard us talking earlier, he is an alumnus of Heath High School, which we will have Heath next week when they take on Bloom Carroll in Division 4. regional playoff action.
That will be fun.
Yes, it will. I was sent a picture last night from a friend of mine who attended the Heath game, and it was a picture of Dave Klontzfield. And man, what a man he is! Not just a coach, but what a person, Coach Klontz.
I knew him in some different capacities than Marion, but I can't say enough positive things about Coach Klontz.
Yeah. Touchdown for the Pilots! It is Kramer getting through there. Makes it 52-21, and it will be a running clock for the rest of the way. Hocut comes on to kick the extra point.
And kick the extra point, Zach Hocut.
Extra point is up, and it is good. So with 4:25 to play in the contest, the River Pilots take a 53-21 lead. We want to say thanks to our Interphase Video Productions crew tonight. Josh Besserly is our producer-director. Also in the truck with him is Shane Messina and Donnie Ziegfeld. On cameras tonight, out in the cold. Down on the field is Tom Russo. Up in the our mid-level camera is Jason Roush, and up on high atop the stadium is Jim Spires. Those guys do a great job every week, so we thank them for all their work tonight, and we certainly want to thank the folks here at Berne Union. Always a nice setup. There's Tom down on the field. But folks here at Berne Union do a nice job and always welcome us and give us plenty of room and supply us with everything we need here in the press box.
Very appreciative.
Danny Snively, the athletic director, who's done a good job here in Sugar Grove over the last few years in his role.
Guys, Tom always wins the award for the least amount of clothes when it gets cold out here. He's out here in a flannel and a T-shirt.
Maybe he's a football coach.
And he's no gloves, and it's like it's not even bothering him.
Look at
I'm
him.
Over here freezing. I've got like seven layers on.
He's a gamer.
Marion, he's a penguin. He's from Youngstown.
That's right, yeah.
That makes sense.
This isn't cold to him at all.
Not at all.
53-21 is a score. Pilots lead it with 4:25 to play. They will kick it off to Berne Union. Coming up, we will have our players of the game. One from each team. Also want to tell you that coming up at the end of this contest, we will hopefully have a conversation with Mike Flannery down on the field. Marion will be talking to the victorious head coach of the River Pilots, Coach Flannery, immediately following this contest as Hocut kicks off. After a penalty, he kicked it off from the 45-yard line. So there was no doubt he was going to kick that one into the end zone. Well, Shue, with 4:20 to play in the game, and it's going to be a running clock, let's go ahead and get to our players of the game. Let's do the Berne Union player of the game first, brought to you by Park National Bank. Park National Bank is a family of community banking teams delivering an exceptional breadth and depth of resources to individuals and businesses, providing a hands-on, personalized approach to service and strong local leadership that invests deeply in the places we live and work. Park National Bank, where you mean more. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
I think when you talk about the Rockets tonight, the player that stands out is Nate Nemeth. You know, the quarterback, he can run, he can throw. He put a couple passes right on the money tonight. Played good defensively in the secondary. Just congrats to Nate. He is a big factor in the season that the Rockets have had.
So congratulations to the quarterback, Nate Nemeth, number 12 for the Rockets, the Berne Union player of the game. Let's get to our River player of the game, brought to you tonight by the Edwards Insurance Agency, specializing in providing personalized insurance coverage that meets the needs of our individual clients. Contact Todd or Dale Edwards today.
You know, we just talked about how many offensive weapons they have and how many good things they do between, you know, the Kramer twins and Lolathan and Longwell and River Thompson. But I tell you, I just really think Cable Isley makes them go. He just stirs the drink, man. He can do a lot of things. For a young player, he is really under control, knows what he's doing, and makes great reads offensively.
And he had an outstanding game on the defensive side as well.
He probably had the two best hits we've seen.
Here goes Nemeth across midfield. And he's pushed out of bounds at about the 35. I tell you, give credit to 81 for River.
Longwell.
Yeah, that's Longwell. I mean, that looked like Nimmo's going to take that to the house, and Longwell came running in. Here's a late flag coming in. Rockets losing their cool now.
Yeah, you can't do that. You know, just
how many is that this quarter? A lot.
Unfortunately, it represents your school and your team in a bad light. You got to quit doing that.
There was nothing wrong with the hit. He just pushed him out of bounds.
Yeah.
Going to back him up after a nice run by Nemeth. And now another one. I mean, this is getting out of control.
Yeah, that's unfortunately that's going to reflect on your school and your coaches. You got to get a handle on that.
Sure do. That's at least five unsportsmanlike penalties tonight I've seen on Berne Union.
Well, unfortunately, you know, you haven't been in this situation. They're just not really sure how to handle it, Jared.
So wipe out that nice long run from Nate Nemeth. And here comes another one. And he has tossed somebody out of the game.
Yeah, that's the best thing to do.
Yeah, you might as well.
Remove the player.
So Nate Nemeth gets ejected from the contest. Timeout. 2:03 to play in the game. Rockets trail at 53-21. It's unfortunate, Shu.
Yeah, it is. You know how I feel about that stuff and those kind of things.
Me too.
You know. Hey, I've always said young people will make mistakes.
Yeah.
I've always said that.
Yep.
But you just need to teach them and hold them accountable for actions.
Yep.
And they need to understand why. And there's nothing wrong with dealing with them and teaching them. You have to learn how to handle frustration.
Yep. So we'll see who comes in at quarterback now for the Berne Union Rockets after Nate Nemeth is kicked out of the game for multiple unsportsmanlike conducts. I don't even know how they're going to mark this off. There were two. There was one immediately after the play. Then there was another one here. And then did we have two more once they backed it up past the 50?
Yeah, I think so. I don't know. I once saw a football game years and years ago where there was a situation with multiple penalties and the team had to kick off to the other team, and the team was kicking to them from their 10.
Oh, wow. That's crazy.
I know.
So what is this, 50 yards in penalties on this play? If there's four 15-yarders?
Well, that's 60.
60 yards? Yeah, you're the math guy. Quick math.
Yeah, well.
Let's see. I believe it'll be Austin Snyder. He's listed as a quarterback, number 6. Sophomore. Maybe not. Looks like maybe number 11, Jarrett Thompson, a freshman, 5'9", 140-pounder, will play quarterback. And he hands it off to Schaefer. Gets a carry across the 20.
And guys,
second down and 7 coming up. Go ahead, Marion.
Excuse me, guys. There was a shot, you know, at the end here on the sideline with Nemeth, Osma, and Frasner all on the, you know, sideline, obviously dejected. Those have really been the three main cogs of really the team all season long. They were, you know, just all sitting on the bench. Coach Herbst came around, made them all stand up, said, guys, stand up. You cheer on these guys. You know, just a show of class for Coach Herbst to you know, require that they stay involved.
Good carry there, or recovery by Lolithan. So back to River it goes. First and 10 with a minute to play.
Well, I think they'll probably just go take a knee here, Jared, or something straight up the middle.
And if you're Coach Flannery, you know, the thing you got to tell your guys is don't do anything stupid. Don't react to anything. They've got another game to play. You don't want to get anybody ejected and miss anything for the remainder of the playoffs.
They're just going to kneel on it here.
There are post-game ejections also in Ohio
sports.
That's
true. I actually saw it in a basketball game one time and a baseball game recently.
Yeah, I had somebody I was umpiring with had one time, and it's just not good. It's just not good, Jared. It's not necessary, and it's not good.
Yeah.
And believe me, I had times where in my younger days, I embarrassed myself a couple times, and it's just not necessary.
Yeah.
Now, the kids seem fine here.
So the River Pilots will move on in the Division 7, Region 27 playoffs as they come to Sugar Grove and walk away with an 53-21 victory over the Rockets of Berne Union. This River football team is a good one. They're going to be forced to be reckoned with in these playoffs, I think.
Yeah, very impressive tonight. Like I said, Berne had no answer defensively for how good River's offense is.
So as they shake hands at midfield, we will hopefully get a word with Coach Flannery. At the end of this, after they shake hands, Marion Royster will be tracking him down. There's a good look at him shaking hands at midfield. Coach Flannery in his 19th season as the head coach at River, 39th overall. And as we mentioned earlier tonight, his dad started the football program in 1957 at River High School. Field is named after him. So, boy, what a tradition it is for Flannery's in football at River High School. So,
and it is right on the river, Jared. If you would look on the map and look up Hannibal, right across the river is West Virginia.
So we've got Marion down there with Coach Flannery. We will get our camera guy over ready to go, and we'll help. We'll hope to get Coach Flannery away quickly. So let's send it down on the field to Marion Royster, standing by with Coach Flannery.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with head coach of the River Pilots, Coach Mike Flannery. Coach, you know, so much came in and talking about the Berne Union offense, how, you know, explosive they were. But you guys were pretty explosive in your own right, scored a lot of points tonight. Seemed like a total team effort with you guys.
You know, we mixed it up a lot. We was just feeling it out at the beginning and then just seeing what they were giving us defensively. They got some big dudes and they got some nice athletic kids, and we were really concerned about that, getting a push on them up front.
Yeah, well, it seemed like you had a game plan that you executed really to perfection. You know, took a lot of time off the clock there, you know, and they were able to score on that first drive, and then you were able to take some big shots down the field and mix that in as well. Were able to really execute everything you seemed to want to.
The one play where they scored on a long touchdown pass and then we came back and answered with another touchdown pass, I think was a big factor right there, because we just traded and our kids was ready to get down a little bit. I was concerned with, but we got it right back. We got some playmakers, and I got great kids. I can't say enough about our kids.
What do you take from this game, this win, onto the rest of the playoffs for you?
Well, just keep it going. You know, enjoy tomorrow, refocus, and get more energized for next week. We're going to be okay next week. These guys play Shadyside, and they got us once, 14-12, and we're ready for them this time.
Congratulations, Coach. Good luck to you the rest of the way. Thank you.
I saw you play basketball, too, by the way.
Once upon a time? Okay, right, thanks, yeah. Coach. Appreciate it. Thank you.
We're good.
I was okay. Thanks.
I love it.
Back to you guys.
Love it. Wow.
Wow. You're more well-known than you think, Marion. You're too humble.
Wow. Coach Flannery with the how about that? Boy, nice comments there from Coach Flannery. I love the enthusiasm, and I love the confidence and the, you know, hey, we're ready. We're ready for next week to bring on Shadyside, right?
Yeah, and apparently he's a guy with an excellent memory, because I played, you know, almost three decades ago now, and he still remembered me playing, so God bless him.
Well, Marion, great job braving the cold temperatures, and we'll see you next week.
Absolutely.
That's
looking
gonna be
forward
a fun
to
one,
it.
Isn't it.
Yeah, it's going to be a fun one. You know, one of the most dominant teams that we've seen in Fairfield County in quite some time in this Berne Union team, and my alma mater. I mean, it really doesn't get much better than that for me selfishly, so I'm really looking forward to it. Should be a good one.
All right. Once again, your final score tonight, 53-21. A fun one tonight here in Sugar Grove, and looking forward to next week and Bloom Carroll taking on Heath.
Yeah, I knew there'd be some fireworks tonight, but it was really one-sided for the most part. And got to give a big shout out to both teams. I thought River played extremely well, very, very well schooled offensively and defensively. And say congrats to Berne. You see the seniors here probably walking out here to the middle. You got to give them a big shout out for a heck of a season. You don't get a win 10 games or 9 games or whatever it is. I think they won 10. They were 10-0 coming in. You just don't get that. You earned those. So congrats to them. And Coach Herp's done a fine job this year. But this River team is for real.
Yes, they are.
And I haven't seen Shady Side, obviously, but Coach Flannery's team, they can play.
Yes, they can. Well, once again, I want to say thanks to our Interphase Video Productions crew tonight. Josh Messerly, Shane Messina, Donnie Ziegfeld, Jason Roush, Tom Russo, and Jim Spires. Your final score tonight from Sugar Grove, it's the River Pilots 53, Berne Union 21. I want to say thanks to our entire crew from Interphase Video Productions for our sideline reporter, Marion Royster, and my sidekick up here, Tim Shoemaker. I have to look up to him. He had a joke on me this evening. He's got he said I needed the high stool. But, Tim, great job. We'll see you next week. Again, your final score, 53-21. Have yourselves a great night, everybody.